So, Megan.
Yes.
We always, any guest we have, we ask a question to.
Okay.
They never.
So I'm afraid it is a Mary Boff Kill question.
It's a. Okay. That's fine. I don't know if I have an answer off the top of my head, but I'll do my best.
You can think about it. That's Tigger, cool. Hobbs, and Garfield. But three stripy cats.
Tigger.
Hobbs.
And Garfield. Hobbs.
Which one? Well, that'd be for Mary?
I'd marry Tigger because he's sweet and kind.
Interesting.
I would probably buff Hobbs because he's got those, like...
Intellectual.
There's something... He's intellectual and he's sort of long in stature. He's tall. Yes, he's tall, which I like.
He's tall.
I come from a family of very tall men, so
okay.
I think that's...
Plus he's got that hairy kind of chesty bit, that poofy bit.
Oh, it's he does. Like it's kind of a...
Man. You could
snuggle
with that.
Yeah, it's a man.
He's like, hey, you want to go outdoors? I love the outdoors.
Yeah, that's true. He likes sledding. And then you kill Garfield.
And then I kill Garfield because Garfield just annoys me.
Yeah. Interesting. I think everybody has unanimously be kill Garfield.
No, I said I think I was going to marry Garfield.
Oh, you're going to marry Garfield. That says a lot about you.
Keep it on his toes.
And your wife.
And Tigger and I were going to, you know what, bounce up and down.
Yeah, most people go marry Hobbs because he's a bit more peaceful. And they want to buff Tigger because he's
excitable.
Fun. Yeah. And they want to kill Garfield because he's a slob, basically.
Weird.
I just love Hobbs, so he's also an asshole. Yeah.
Yeah, it's interesting that my answer was slightly reverse of everyone else's. I didn't think about that. Where Tigger is very energetic, he'd be a lot of fun in the bedroom.
Energetic.
But
I'm surprised.
Yes. I'm sure he's bound to settle down once we marry. Isn't that how it works? You can change a tiger.
Yeah, there's the female thinking.
It never works.
He's a broken man. I can change him.
He's a broken man. Surely I can change him.
He's a project.
Geeks.
Geeks!
Hello and welcome to episode 34 of Geeks, the world's number one entertainment podcast recorded in this room. It's also the world's number one horticultural website podcast recorded in this room. I'm your host, Al White. I like to order chicken ramen, but without the chicken. I tried to play discus for a while at school, and sometimes I can't sleep until 5 a.m. in the morning because I'm just too overwhelmingly depressed.
Yeah.
Aww.
Joining me today for this very special... You know, you're up with me. Joining me today for this very special episode, Kung Fury, Justin Mariconda.
Hi-ya!
The love poet, Alexander Chard.
Ooh.
SpongeBob. You really fucked me up. SpongeBob SquarePants, the movie, Adrian Auld. Did I say that right?
Boing.
And our very, very special guest, Dancing Ninja, Megan Sullivan is here.
Yeah!
Thank you, Megan.
Yay, anime.
Yay, anime. Don't
can
you,
I swear on this podcast?
Can,
I can.
Yeah. Say what you
yay
want.
Yay, fucking anime.
Oh,
whoa.
You don't understand. So if you don't know who I am, and that's okay, you probably don't. I'm from IGN, and we have a podcast called IGN Anime Club. And it's open to all ages, and we can't swear on the show. Don't really swear on any of our shows unless we have to bleep it out.
Yep.
So I'm like, I want to be Megan After Dark. You know,
I remember that moment where it changed over IGN and suddenly there was no swearing anymore. And it was very disconcerting.
It was a little disconcerting for a lot of people, but because we got so huge and we got a little broader in our audience, we're like, yeah, we should probably tone this down so we can sponsor more stuff and make more money.
So how does that work?
Blue Star Donuts. Would anyone like a Blue Star Donut?
they have coffee too. Donuts and coffee.
Oh, who'd have thought? You know, donuts, coffee.
Tell me to shut up if I'm asking like stuff I'm not meant to ask about interior of IGN. But your UK and your Australian ones are still allowed to swear. How does that work? Their podcast.
Because it's fucking Australia.
Yeah, mate. It's
you
from
guys,
down under.
The Australian one, like
that's
they really swear.
Like that's all.
You order fuck. No, that's not Australia.
Yeah, don't do that again.
Yeah.
I don't know why they get to do it. Maybe because they're just a little looser in the UK and Australia, and we're very Puritan uptight in America.
It's true.
We can't do that, and our sponsors are a little more strict things. Like in Europe, you can show boobies all the time. Here, it's like, you can kill 50 people on TV, but boobies? Oh, no!
Yep. Sex doesn't happen, but violence does.
Yeah.
And that's the American rule. Do you know the Dragon Ball thing of when they adapted Dragon Ball Z to America? And the money they use to repaint, you know, cells and stuff.
Oh, yeah. There's all sorts of weird censorship in, like, Dragon Ball and Sailor Moon and all this other crazy stuff.
So my favorite one is the one where, I've forgotten his name. Is it Master Roshi, is it? The turtle dude?
Yeah.
Where he used to be led around and he'd use in Japanese version by a girl's panties. Would lead him around from place to place because he was a pervert.
Yeah.
In the American one, they had to paint him out. So they meticulously spent millions of dollars getting people to paint him out. What did they replace it with? Wads of cash. Just wads of fucking cash, because it was okay for him to be greedy and just driven by capitalism, but driven by sex wasn't all right. Which I just thought summed up the difference between Japan and America.
Well, no, see, yeah, in the 90s Sailor Moon, Uranus and Neptune, who are lovers, became cousins. So now you had kissing cousins, which made it a whole lot worse.
America.
I don't know,
they're
but
just
it's
very
just,
loving.
Yes, they're very loving female cousins. And it was like, something is strange about this. They seem very close to as cousins. That I don't think I'm close to my cousins that way. Turns out that they're a couple, but can't have that.
Yeah. That is a crazy flip.
I didn't think that
is the more sensible choice.
Yeah, I don't know that they're cousins. Okay. I don't know what part of the U.S. you thought this was okay. I mean, this must have been decided in the South somewhere.
This is my kind of show. Yeah. Good cousin. They're probably first and second.
I can already tick off my voices. My voices dream on the podcast for one episode.
Sorry, but I couldn't help myself.
By the way, all the precursors on your names this week were David Hasselhoff films.
Ah,
we'll learn why later.
Mm. Sorry, wait. What did I get again?
You got The Love Boat.
The Love Boat.
Mm.
That was a film.
He's in it.
Or the TV series.
I don't know. I looked on IMDb and this is what
happened. TV series. The Love Boat.
I don't watch all the David Hasselhoff films.
Isn't SpongeBob?
He's a voice in the SpongeBob SquarePants the movie.
He's actually himself, right? He usually plays himself in those. What was that again?
You got Kung Fury.
Oh.
Megan got the best one, Dancing Ninja.
Interesting cultural note about Daisy.
Did you know Dirty Dancing in France is called Sexy Dance?
Oh, Dirty Dancing?
Not Dirty Dancing, Step Up.
Step Up
is called Sexy Dance in France. It's a true story.
And that was the last he ever spoke.
My favorite was Step Up 3, which is Sexy Dance World Battle.
Why did they get all the cool names over there? That's so much better.
Where?
France. It's a mythical place. You won't know about it.
Okay.
All right.
Amazing.
How has everyone been? What have you been doing this week? Let's start with our guest, Megan.
So I am down in LA to cover the Square Enix Final Fantasy unveiling event, where it's this big, epic 2-hour event where they're going to talk about Final Fantasy's release date.
Yes. 15, we're talking about.
We're talking about Final Fantasy 15 and some other stuff that I can't disclose because it's all under embargo till tomorrow. Which really sucks because I know stuff and I want to talk about it, but I can't.
This won't go out until tomorrow.
Yeah.
So maybe not. I'm trying to figure out when it is live tomorrow, so it is.
If you go online, you can actually watch it happening.
Cool.
Which is very cool. That's why I'm down here. Otherwise, I am just watching a lot of anime, and yep, that's it. That's my whole life: games and anime. And
did you guys pick a new anime in your anime book club thing on the show yet? I haven't caught up.
I'm sorry, what?
Because you finished Gurren Lagann.
Oh, yeah, we finished that, and then we are now doing, for our watch party, we're doing Shidobako, which is anime about making anime.
Oh, that one.
Very meta. Meddy.
Folks,
I have not gotten sleep in 48 hours, and I'm going to say some loopy stuff tonight.
Plus, you've been drinking Medi all day, which just, is it good, that one?
Yes, it is. It's very good. It's a slice of life anime, so it's a little slower than what some people are normally into, but it's very funny.
I love slice of life.
And it was between that one and Psycho Pass, which is from the makers of Ghost in the Shell.
Ooh. Yes.
Ooh. Yes, good stuff.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Which is not a slice of life
Shell.
Anime.
Shell. That's what we're wooing about, right?
Yeah.
We like shells.
Shells. Sexy ghost shells.
I love slice of life anime. It's my favorite stuff. We were talking about that before. I said I used to like Tenchi Muyo, and I used to like the episodes where they did nothing and didn't battle space pirates or space rabbits that turned into spaceships. Instead, they just stayed at home and cooked.
Yeah, just everyday, just everyday life.
They did also go into the hot springs.
Oh, yeah.
They would.
You gotta have hot springs episode. That's a requirement.
Some nose bleeding because you're thinking bad thoughts. I remember
for those of you watching.
Yeah, can
I remember
you straight to camera?
And there's a meme. I remember being so confused when I think that was the first show I really noticed the nose bleeding for dirty thoughts in anime. And I didn't know what was going on. I was like, has he got an aneurysm? Is there a like what's happening? Has he got a disease? Is this gonna get really dark at some point? But no, just sexy thoughts.
Sexy thoughts.
But did it ever happen? Was there like one Japanese dude who thought such sexy thoughts, he got a nosebleed, and then from then on out it's just canon?
Well, it takes a lot of brain power, you know. And then usually, if you get a lot of blood in your head, you get a nosebleed.
Well, it's rushing down somewhere.
So
a little leaks out the nose along the way.
Yeah. Comes out.
Whoops,
that's not
way.
The right way.
Yeah.
Meanwhile,
how good is
Final Fantasy VII. That was great, wasn't it?
You want to talk about Final Fantasy VII? That's what you want to do right now.
It's really good.
Are you fucking kidding me?
All right, wait, maybe now's not the time, but I just...
There is a remake coming out, very like a...
It was really good.
Kind of a remake.
So when you say Final Fantasy unveiling...
Ready for it.
At this event. Is it... Because they've unveiled 15. Are they
so
unveiling...
they've unveiled 15, so they're actually going to unveil the release date.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
So, yes.
I mean, yes.
You don't have to say it twice. Just pick a distance.
I said yes, but I was, you know, not close. Cute. But then I wanted to get real close so they could hear my voice.
Well, how about just think before you say it, and then choose a distance.
That sounds too complicated.
That's too much.
Man.
All right, you do it twice. Sorry, Megan. Please continue. Sorry.
I forget what we were talking. We were talking about Final Fantasy 15. The release date. A couple other things that they're going to show off.
Cool.
Yep. And then someone brought up Final Fantasy VII, and there is a remake coming, which if you actually compare the original PlayStation 1 battle scenes and cutscenes to what they showed of the new, quote-unquote, Final Fantasy VII, it's almost one-to-one at times. It's pretty crazy.
And only slightly prettier.
Yes,
oh,
and I think it's going to be episodic, if I'm remembering this correctly, which a lot of people are complaining about, but when you think about it, instead of waiting 5 years for one game, you wait maybe... 1 year for each episode or something.
Like, you know, Game of Thrones or something.
Yeah, and you get a lot of more coverage.
Yeah, but the thing is, that's fine if, like, Game of Thrones, the thing is, you know it's out every week, whereas most episodic games, you know, and I'm not saying, like, their job's incredibly hard for what they're trying
to do. Dude?
I know what you're saying. Telltale!
I'm saying we wait around for months for something to come out, and it doesn't come out. By the time it does, you've forgotten everything, and you don't really care anymore. That's my problem with
Telltale!
Telltale's! Yeah,
it's so true.
I'm not sure what you're saying when you do that.
So,
I'll tell you later.
Did you see Batman v Superman? Yep.
I didn't see it yet, but I did listen to your guys' podcast last week with all the spoilers, and I thought it was very interesting. No, it's good. It was. It's interesting because I still don't know where I sit because it seemed like everyone's on the middle. Either people love it, hate it, or they're right in the middle where they're like, I love certain things about it, but other stuff was painfully bad. Mm. So.
Yeah, well, I was saying that. You very kindly let me crash your lunch. And I was saying, yeah, I don't know how people can have one opinion on the other. I feel you have to be muddled because it's a very muddled film. And there's so much going on in it.
Yeah, it's very convoluted is what it sounds like.
Very convoluted.
But it is a big setup for Justice League, I believe, because, ha, Dawn of Justice.
It's a big setup.
Hey.
A big forced setup.
He's our DC boy. We're Marvel. He's DC.
No, I'm just a comic book kind of guy. Mm-hmm. I like whatever tickles my
imagination. You said your allegiances on Batman versus Superman podcast. You're now firmly the DC guy on this podcast.
If it makes you feel better, all my answers to every comic book question will be Batman.
Yes.
That's because still a pretty
good
answer.
Who is married to Mary Jane Parker?
Batman.
True story.
Which she should be. she wants a real man.
Adrian. So for people who didn't meet you, you're on. You kindly came and did the Batman v Superman spoiler cast with us.
Yes, I did.
If anyone hasn't listened to that, go back and listen to that now because you've probably seen the movie. So what's the harm?
Yeah.
Other than you waste 2 hours listening.
Go check it out.
Adrian, how's your week been?
Week's been good. For those who don't know, I'm newly arrived in Los Angeles.
Los Angeles.
All right.
Because they will fucking whip you with wet towels if you say Los Angeles.
Los Angeles.
Yeah.
See, I'm learning things every day.
When Al and I were traveling together across the States, I think we were in Utah. Remember?
We were doing our honeymoon.
Yeah, we were doing our honeymoon. We were in Utah in these beautiful canyons at the car park. And we're talking to this older couple. We're like, yeah, we're going to Los Angeles. Yeah, and she's like, they say Los Angeles.
She really fucking... She was being really sweet, and then she just flipped like that. Ooh, okay. So ever since then, I'm just doing you a favor.
I appreciate it.
That made the hot tub a little awkward. All right.
And so what about Los Feliz?
Los Feliz, because Feliz Navidad.
Facts.
People say Los Feliz?
There's so many different pronunciations.
Because you say Los Feliz, because Feliz Navidad, but people... you say Los Feliz.
Los Feliz.
Feliz, because Feliz Navidad.
I'm going to kill myself with a kazoo.
But people say... What's the other one? I can't even
Los
say...
Los Feliz?
Feliz. Yeah, Feliz. Which is not... You don't say Feliz Navidad. That sounds stupid.
It does
read
sound
a book.
Stupid.
Enjoy Spanish holidays.
So for those of you still with us, these are all places in Los Angeles region.
Yeah, so, you know, send in your questions and everybody can get straight on pronunciation. But no, this week I have been looking for housing. And that's been great.
It's a fun search.
Yeah, it's going to be good to get off the street finally. That's a joke.
If you can just stop staring through people's windows, would be nice.
But, well, you know, I do what I can.
It always looks nice inside.
And just to clear it up, it is Santa Barbara, in case you ever go up north.
Did you say Santa Barbara?
It's Barbara.
Yeah, Barbara.
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 Okay. Thank you.
That's a Flight of Conchords reference.
I like how this became a language studies group.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, this is how you
and
actually...
it's San Francisco.
To be honest with you, Megan, not many people are listening yet, so it can be whatever we want it to be.
You don't know how this is going to blow
we'll
up.
Fine.
This might be the groundbreaking episode, because now people know how to pronounce Los Angeles.
That's true.
Thanks to this.
And Santa Barbara, which I didn't know was the pronunciation.
Santa Barbara.
Santa Barbara. Barbara. Santa Barbara. Yeah, Santa Barbara, man. It's Santa Barbara.
Anyone? No, no. Okay, Justin.
Yes.
I am kind of scared to ask how your week has been.
Well, glad you asked, Al. Since I was last here, I just packed up my things because they were sanding the floors at the place I'm living at, and moved
sanding
it into
the floors.
Yeah, because it's a hardwood floor, and they need to like buff it out. So there's sawdust everywhere.
Oh.
And I slept on a couch and mowed some lawn.
Wait, so you've just moved to a new place?
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Now you've had to move out because
I didn't move out. I moved my things from my room into this office room.
Okay.
And so everything's like packed. I didn't even get to unpack yet. And yeah, and then I bombed an audition, and here I am.
You bombed an audition?
Yeah.
What happened?
Can you say what for? Or
I was for Taco Bell. Actually, I don't know because they could probably bring me back. But I feel like it went terribly. Everyone there was like late mid-30s. I'm this young guy. For those who can't see
careful
me on
you
the
say, mate.
YouTube,
I've learned to tune him out a long time ago.
Anywho, I went in, did my thing, and then I realized, wow, I just seemed very too laid back for Taco Bell.
and the fucking bomb drop.
That was the best sentence in the world.
I'm too laid back for Taco Bell. That, sir, is too fucking laid back.
Oh,
that's all that is.
That was a wonderful quote.
And then, that was it, man.
All right.
That was my week. Now I'm just drinking it away.
Well, you can join us in our conference text at 5 in the morning when we're crying and can't get to sleep. Alex, how's your week been?
Hey, what up? my week's been fine. I've been hosting Adrian and showing him some of the sights.
Showing the streets.
Although we did leave him on the weekend. Bethany and I went up to Big Bear for a friend's 30th.
Was that your first time, Big Bear?
Yep. It's awesome.
It's like
I was so excited.
Shrunken Tahoe.
Yeah, and it's so close. 2 hours.
Yep.
Awesome.
Had a great time. A few auditions this last week. None for Taco Bell, I'm afraid.
These two normally get the same auditions, which is great.
We almost worked together. We almost worked together on another project. Crazy. Remember, we could have probably been the lovers.
I know. But instead they chose another lover for me.
Yeah. Was it good enough?
Oh, so you got the role and Justin didn't.
No, I
interesting. He had another job.
Yeah, I had another
Justin's
job.
Justin's the commercial king, might
he
I
is
add.
The commercial. Your show reel's ridiculous.
Very commercial.
He is the
I like it
king.
When you're playing too late when you're back. Playing Battlefield 4. That was my favorite day of yours.
Oh, that was me actually playing though.
You were actually playing.
That was
you
my
just...
footage.
Oh really?
Yeah.
That's what they use
so
your...
Or is that not from a commercial and you just uploaded footage of you from Battlefield?
Yeah, Battlefield. Oh, sick. No. Because I was doing playtest with them. And then they're like, hey, we want to interview you. I'm like, you guys want to interview me? Shit. Told two stories. That was the story they chose. The other one I had was about how we were trying to capture a point. And it was like, they're letters. They're like A, B, C, and D. It was like on the map of Battlefield.
Oh.
Anyways, we.
So
anyways, we're trying to capture this point, and everyone's just shouting on the mics, like, "Get the D, get D!" And they didn't use that, of course, because it's inappropriate.
What if your name was D? That'd be upsetting.
Yeah. D, dude. Sorry.
Anything else?
Finally, Ty and I, my writing partner, came up with a name for our short/web series.
You did.
Did. I told you this afternoon.
As one of your producers, I'm going to urge you not to reveal it right now.
And I will take your advice. Thank you. So, there you go. That's what I've been up to.
I enjoyed it.
What would the working title be if you were going to give a title?
Ding Dong Go the Bells from the Clock Tower.
Sweet.
Very apt.
Yeah.
Very apt.
What about you, Al?
I was watching some Daredevil. Like a couple of episodes left. Really fucking loved this second season. I think the first season is... all good, and then there's a couple of great episodes this second season. I think it's all fucking great, and there's a couple of good episodes.
And do you feel out because I think you mentioned on the podcast before he's your favorite
comic book.
Daredevil's superhero. Always been my favorite.
He's
superhero.
Up top of the list. Yeah. Does this honor the comics?
This is really fucking getting close. And what's weird with it, and I don't give any spoilers, but the further you get through this season, they really delve into some very recent stuff that happened in the comics that was quite controversial and people didn't like. So I'm intrigued of some of the story paths they're going on. But it's very, it's proper Daredevil world now. Like, yeah, it's cool. Very cool. Yeah.
Totally agree with you.
Shut up. I went to Palm Springs for the first time.
How's that?
Didn't do it for me. It just felt like bits of LA or bits of Vegas, but without the cool bits of either of them. Like, there were some nice restaurants,
Palm
some
Springs
nice bars.
South?
It's east.
East. Like east. In the desert.
Yeah, it was completely fine. It's a nice place, but it didn't have anything. It just had stuff that LA already has, but LA has more stuff.
Is there a film festival there?
Yeah.
Was the film festival on?
No.
Did you ride a motorcycle?
I've been in full pre-production for the first time now on our film, which is very exciting. It's a big thing.
Congratulations.
We're moving into casting right now and locations, which we might be shooting somewhere kind of cool, which is nearer than I thought, which I'm excited about. I was playing a little bit of Dark Souls, trying to get ready for Dark Souls 3. I'm excited.
Dark Souls. Demon's Souls is still my favorite, though. I'm just
really?
Throwing that out there. I don't know. It's the first game in the Souls series, and it really clicked with me. I actually rage quit the hell out of that game the first time I played it, and then it was free on PSN like 6 months later. So I went back, and I finally got past the tutorial stage, which is like the hardest, because the game will whip you and discipline you until you get this right. You don't run. Shield up. Cautious, you know, like you have a plan, you have a strategy. I mean, this game will punish you otherwise.
Oh, fuck yeah.
And I finally got past the first level and I was like, get it, it's brilliant. And that's my courageous
that's your
Demon's
Soul
story.
And then you just threw it down.
I actually had to stop halfway though, because it was so tense. That game is so atmospheric that I actually had to quit, because I was like shaking and like on the edge of my seat, and I was like, this is stressing me out. I
sounds
can't do
awesome.
This Yeah, and so I'm like, if you guys still haven't played Demon's Souls, the one that started it all, go back and play that game. And in some ways,
I
think it's still prettier than some of the Souls games.
It is a war of attrition, those games. They really are. It's just like pushing upstream.
Yeah.
And then it's the stuff that they do not tell you at all. My actual first one, I played a tiny bit of Demon's Souls, but not much when it first came out. Dark Souls 2 was the first one I really played, which is everyone's least favorite one. But, and then I went back
the Emerald Herald
to Demon's Souls 1.
Seek. Last.
But you have no fucking clue what's going on. And you're playing it, and then you suddenly realize, oh, if I do this, then I've forever lost life. You know that? And I don't know how to get it back. And just weird stuff that happens to you that's terrifying. What are you guys doing? And I've actually...
They're ignoring us.
I was watching your IGN. You got the UK team are doing Dark Souls with one of their noobs like this.
Yes, prepare to try.
Prepare to try. I've been doing that each night, because it goes up every day, and it's about an hour long. And I'm just watching. It's just hilarious. Just watching.
It's
like
stuff.
The two of them.
It's
one guy who's clearly knows every inch of Dark Souls 1.
Yeah.
And the other guy's played it a bit. And then this new kid for it. And just watching their reactions is incredible. Just their exasperation. Then you're cutting. And you'll watch them in almost real time for 40 minutes get to somewhere. And then he'll fuck it up and die. And he got to a bonfire and didn't properly save it.
So
then they go
no.
back. And then you just cut. And you just got them all just sitting there. And they're getting sweatier or just more angry. And one of them just like literally is just, I'm not just going to quit this series. I'm leaving the fucking job. I'm getting out of this industry.
I've never played any of these games. They sound impossible to break into.
No, but that's the whole point, is you start and there's a wall, and for the rest of the game, you're pushing that wall.
Yeah.
That's literally all the game is.
You get like Stockholm Syndrome from it.
But you have to enter it with a certain type of personality, you know, that you're going into.
Disorder.
It. Exactly. You kind of do. But you have to be like, I want to fucking beat this game. And I never play games for that.
Sounds like an addiction.
But that's really what it is. It's just like, I have to fucking beat it.
Your pride is almost on the line.
Yeah.
Like, you gotta beat it.
It's got a good hook.
I don't like repeating stuff. And that, these games, you just repeat. Yeah. And I hate repeating anything in life in general. So I just don't
stay away from JRPGs.
Yeah, I don't like JRPGs.
That game just sounds... Like, I've seen people play it, and I just can't do games like that. Because when I was a kid, I have a scar on my finger from fucking... Street Fighter. I was so angry. I like slammed the controller, and
you
the circle on the back of it scarred my finger. I have a scar. Oh,
you have battle scars.
Yeah,
so
you would break many things.
Yeah, I would. I'd be like those YouTube videos where the kids like break their keyboards in half, throw controllers through the wall.
What is Dark Souls 3? Is the hardest one.
Well, I'm gonna beat it. I'm gonna be the first one.
This
Watch
is
out.
This is an American thing. We talked about this. The beat it.
America.
Like, we don't, in England, we say complete. Like, well, I completed that game.
Yeah,
in America,
this is a game that beats
beat
your ass.
I pushed it to the floor and I kicked it in the ribs.
Yeah.
Kicked its ass.
I'm not going to complete it. I'm going to fuck it up.
Very, very quickly before we start the podcast properly. This is the longest intro of all time.
We're still in the intro.
I've been delving into the world of 4K, and this is something we don't bring up tech very much on this podcast, but I want to here because I've discovered some interesting things. So 4K is here properly. Last year it pretended to be here, but it wasn't because they started to bring out Blu-rays with like mastered in 4K, which literally meant nothing.
When you say here, you mean for the home?
Yeah, it's now here for the home. So yeah. 4K, for anyone who doesn't know, it's what you're watching when you go to a cinema. That's what they're projecting is 4K, 90 plus whatever percent at the time.
Thanks for that. Oh, I didn't know what you're talking about.
Okay. It's also what most films will shoot in. Well, they'll normally be 6K to 8K now, but you won't project it, you know, really in much over 4K.
Now I know what you mean. Yep.
So now, like at home, you can get your TV screen. So now they've been around for a couple of years, but they've been lying to you. And mastered in 4K Blu-rays have been around for about a year, but they've definitely been lied to you because they're still just Blu-ray technology. So now you can do it. You can buy a proper 4K TV. You can buy a 4K projector. You can buy 4K Blu-ray players. So I was like, okay, I want to like take the leap. I saw the Ultra HD. That's what they're called. The black boxes are called Ultra HD 4K Blu-ray. And there's maybe about 20 of them out at the moment. That's it. But you do have online services. Now, Amazon does streaming 4K. Netflix does streaming 4K. Don't believe it. It's bullshit. You can't stream 4K.
That's what I was going to say. Is that real 4K?
No. It's just, they're lies. But it's like organic, you know? It's just a word that
organic
people use.
Organic lies.
And it lies, yeah.
Okay. And people are like, ooh, I just watched something in 4K.
They sit on a exactly. throne of lies.
There are, however, services. You can buy like a Sony box, which lets you into their server and you can download the films.
Sounds
much
like
iTunes.
A lot of download.
Yeah, you need a seriously
4K,
good bandwidth.
Like, that's a lot yeah. of shit.
So you can
like
rent them or you can buy them.
Hours?
But that's proper 4K. Ultra HD Blu-ray is the easiest way to do it, definitely. You just buy the disc, slip it in. So I thought. So we just upgraded our projector from regular 1080p for a 4K one. I found out, I need a new Blu-ray player. Found out there's only one on the market right now. Only one. And it's from Samsung. There are two more coming,
yes,
hopefully
Samsung.
This spring. Samsung's it. And I love Samsung. So I was like, cool, yeah. I'll get that one. Got one of the better projectors because like, if we're going to do this, I want to go all in. It's for like a business as well. People come see our films and blah, blah, blah. That was my excuse I gave myself anyway.
Yeah, it's a good one.
Got
can
a really
claim
good
that on
Sony.
Tax? Does that work here?
Technically, yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks for reminding. Got a really nice Sony projector. It's like, cool. Set it all up. Everything was already set up. So all I need to do is replace my old Blu-ray, replace the projector. Off you go. Nothing worked. Just kept telling me like this isn't working, the connection's not right, this doesn't support 4K.
Man,
I was like, what the fuck? So I spent about 2 hours just fiddling with leads, trying stuff. No, didn't work. Looks online, not many people are talking about it because everything's too new. This is the problem. Like, not many people really know. There's no videos helping you out or anything yet. Found out then you need to make sure you have special HDMI cables. So I bought one of those. It's the 2.0 HDMI cable you need.
You writing this down?
None of that worked. Yeah. Then I found out there's a technology called 2.22. which your HDMI input and output on the actual receiver and projector stuff have to have. And you have to be using the right ones for that stuff to work because it's a special encoding for 4K, essentially. This was like days later and hours of me throwing stuff by the time I find this stuff out. Like, okay, cool, cool, cool. I have four HDMI leads now. Now, my room's pretty big back there, so they're about 75 feet each one. Four of these fuckers that I've tried because people kept telling me there must be something wrong with your lead. Trying on in the only 2.22 because you have to have a receiver as well. Now your receiver has to have Blu-ray fucking 4K, like 2.22 like in and outputs from it. I have all this set up perfectly. I've gone through it a billion times. I've followed the few guides that there are online.
Your clothes are all torn and raggedy. Your beard's long.
Oh, the hulked out.
<It's> like,
I'm like
sweat. You smell like that weird
discarded HDMI smell. Cables everywhere.
Oh, there are.
You're all tangled.
There are. Up until you guys came around, I hadn't cleaned it up, and it was just everywhere. I was like Tom Hanks in Castaway.
Actually, your house looked really clean when I got here.
Thank
like,
you.
More than usual.
Thank you. I cleaned this
that's
today.
A compliment or an insult.
It's a backhanded compliment.
But I don't want to go on too long about this. All I want to say is 4K is here. I've been on forums all last night talking to people to try and figure out. And people are really nice on those forums. People are really lovely. They're the forums that people are.
So is it working?
But yeah, that's what I want to know. Is it working?
It doesn't work. So it will project, but it will adjust it all to regular HD. It will warn you and say, oh, you're not supporting 2.22, blah, blah, blah. We will just play this in normal HD. And there's a whole different thing called high dynamic range Blu-rays, which certain companies are putting out, which can fuck it even more. And everyone I've talked to online has given me a few things, like try updating this, try updating this. I've got a couple of things still to try. I know they're not going to work because nothing's working. And almost everyone on there is saying, yeah, there's a lot of like, I've had mine for 2 months and these things won't work and there's no way to patch this together and everyone's having troubles with it. So I'm out at the moment. I don't really want to talk about the money, but a stupid amount of money and it doesn't fucking work. It doesn't work yet. And I'm going to figure it out at some point.
I hope so.
But it's exhausting. Yeah.
I'm still stuck on the part where you've said there's a nice internet forum out there. What is that? Like an internet unicorn.
That's what I mean. But for this
for
stuff,
the six
really
guys
nice.
That have 4K at
they're
the moment,
nice.
The six much. Dudes, they're all like just trying to help
so
each other out.
Thank you, AV forums.
Can I just say something on your behalf?
No.
F you 4K.
Yeah, but I want my 4K. I've got the things.
What about like the people who are making this shit? Aren't they like giving
I'll
you
sort
a,
it out?
Have you read? You haven't read the manual yet.
I've read every fucking page of everything, dude.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
And they don't tell you much info. They don't even tell you how to do firmware updates.
Have you called their technical support? The like usually 1-8 or 1-900.
The Sony technical support.
That's a different kind of support.
Yeah. It's just when you're spending this money to do something, it should just fucking work. Yeah. You know, and it's just driven me. It's just driving me absolutely crazy.
Sounds like the American dream.
What happened to the days of a couple of plugs and away you go?
But that's really all there is. That's why it's so completely bewildering.
Have you tried turning it off and on?
No.
Like with the power, you know, like unplug it. Try that.
Have you pulled the projector screen down?
Did you put a Blu-ray in?
Yeah.
I'm sitting there with my Betamax just trying to fit it in. It won't work, guys. Anyway, the lesson is... Don't really investigate this stuff before you buy it because it's just taken up way more of my lifetime than I really want to give it. We're going to start the podcast like we do every week with Nate's Blowdown.
Blowdown.
I'm not Nate though.
Nate isn't here. So me and Justin are going to take over. Justin, you're going to do the game news.
Sweet.
How many items do we have?
We have approximately 7 items.
Okay, please don't do the voices.
Okay, no Nate voice.
And let's do the game things.
I'm doing it right now.
Yeah, do it, man.
Okay.
Game news number one.
Number one.
So Rockstar are reportedly working on GTA 6. It was also revealed that around this time of Vice City, they were also looking at making a GTA set in Japan.
That sounds fucking cool.
Right? But the street structures of Tokyo were too complicated at the time.
Which is kind of true.
Yeah,
as someone who lived in Japan,
you lived in Tokyo.
I lived outside of Tokyo, and the roads are a bit of a mess.
Yeah, it's like
a cluster.
There's a bridge on top of a road that's on.
That room is really interesting to me, and I know there are different departments of Rockstar, but I still want more Red Dead news.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you.
I want Red Dead.
Absolutely.
Red Dead 2.
Plus, you know, this was one of those weird no news things of, oh, they're working on GTA 6. Like, no fucking shit, they're working on GTA 6. GTA 5 has been out for 3 years now.
I also heard they were going to make it like a whole entire United States. I heard that somewhere. I don't know. Maybe that's just internet trash talk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard it was going to be global.
They wanted to build out from GTA Online at one point, but who knows?
Yeah.
All right.
I get lots of money from modders on GTA 5 Online.
You do?
Yeah, I play online on PC. I punched a guy and money sacks fell from him.
Oh,
I got
like
a couple
of
millions.
Real money. Yeah, I thought you made like...
Oh, yeah, real money. Yeah, no.
With those bitcoins.
Number two.
Rumors from industry insiders have said there's a Call of Duty entry on the way set in space.
So I'm going to jump in here with one of our two topic points. Call of Duty. A series that most people at some point did love. Most people do not love it anymore. Unless obviously you're an online multiplayer, you know, in which case it's still, you know, incredibly esteemed. Call of Duty Space, which is what I said this to you earlier, Adrian, you pointed out, this is, well, that's Halo, isn't it, basically? what would it take to get, like, so you guys, any of you guys still love Call of Duty?
I will be honest. The first Call of Duty I played was Ghosts.
That was the first one
I came in like way, way late in the series.
But could you get into it?
Yeah, I finished it. I beat it. But I mean, I wasn't blown away.
Okay,
I finished it because I just started it. So
I just want to know what would it take? What would it take? A Call of Duty? Like here, they're trying to do this Call of Duty Space. That doesn't sound like very exciting to me. What would it take for you guys? What sentence would make you excited in Call of Duty again?
giant robots, but that's like Titanfall, so.
You want like a Robotech?
It's pretty much Titanfall.
You know what? I want to go away from the whole space futuristic thing. And like we were talking about it last week when we were watching an old clip of Medal of Honor. I want a good World War II game.
Yeah.
I would be fine if they went backwards.
Isn't that what Call of Duty has done, one of those, haven't they?
Yeah.
Up until 3.
That was the one I played.
Up until 3. On Xbox 360?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, it was so good.
It was great.
Yeah, it was great.
I was shooting a gun, by the way, in case you wondered.
I couldn't tell if it was that or the rap horn.
I'd be interested in like maybe like a Napoleonic Wars or like a Boer War.
A what war?
Boer War. That was a war in South Africa.
Between the English.
Yeah,
the
English.
The Boers.
Yeah, yeah.
You're welcome.
Who were the Dutch?
Which no one else would be interested in. But
yeah. I'm English.
Yeah,
so
you're English. You have no idea what I'm talking about. No,
I love history. I'd be interested.
No, but like a exception. Maybe like take a step back past World War One or World War Two. Like, you know.
Colonial times? What?
Yeah, crazy.
Muskets.
Megan, what about you? Do you do any first-person shooters at all?
I do. I'm not super great at them, but like I'm playing The Division right now. And I'm replaying Borderlands 2, which is more of a shoot and loot. It's Diablo with guns.
Yeah,
I love Borderlands so much. But anyway, so I think the thing that would get me to play Call of Duty in space is if in the opening sequence they reveal that the whole thing's been funded by Aperture.
Genius.
And you just see Wheatley just be like, space, like somewhere in the background. And that you are helping Lieutenant Ripley... fight aliens.
Are you mixing Portal, Call of Duty, and aliens into one franchise?
If you're asking me what it would take,
tell us more.
That sounds amazing.
I'm just saying, if you want me to play Call of Duty in space, oh, and you have to have a Jason from whichever Friday the 13th.
Jason X.
Jason X when he goes into space.
With the titanium.
Yes. He's got to be like a boss.
This is a mega franchise game.
And now I love this game.
And maybe a lightsaber.
No.
My brain's just completely trapped. You said Jason, and I went, oh.
Yeah, you got to think of things like the easy answer was going to be Star Wars or Star Trek. And it's like, nope, I'm going to go in a different direction. Yeah. We're going to go with Jason in space.
So basically, what we're kind of saying, other than Megan's obviously like winning unicorn idea, is we want Call of Duty to do an Assassin's Creed, really. Play around a bit more with time
first
and
person.
Place.
But I don't know if I want the parkouring of
No, but I just mean in terms of like allow it to move to completely different places in time and just enjoy history.
Was it like that? What was it? 18 something? I don't even know the numbers of that game.
That
is a PlayStation game. The pretty one.
Oh, The Order. 1866.
Oh, the Order.
Yeah. I'm kind of like we've pitched our World War II game many times, which I would love for them to do, but. Yeah, anything just not in the future and not now would be great.
Yeah, and I don't know why that the whole future sort of thing doesn't seem appealing, but it's just, I don't know.
It seems like
it's been bled dry.
I was that guy when we were doing World War II shooters and then they moved to modern times or near future times and everyone was, oh, thank God, because I'm so bored of World War II shooters. I wasn't. I was I can't wait for them to get fed up with the modern shooters coming back to World War II.
Give me a 303 and let me pop people off one shot at a time.
I like the slow pace. I like getting a bit more peaceful moments. Everything's... But I'm an old man now. That's the thing. And kids move at a much faster pace.
That's true.
Watching that IGN, like... Dark Souls thing really showed me because that guy, I've forgotten his name, but he's a lovely, lovely guy. So he's young, way younger than them, and he's just going at it. And at Dark Souls, he's just like, run, do these things, do everything really, really quick. And the rest are like, calm down, dude. Just take it slow.
Just
put your shield up. Like, Ed, never back into a fucking room. And he's just like, oh, what's going on? And running around.
I think that one is with Daniel Krupa, who I absolutely adore. And I am completely blanking on my other coworker's name because I'm a terrible human being. But if you would like to watch Prepare to Try, check it out on IGN.com.
Did it.
Did my duty.
Okay, let's move on. Game news.
Number three.
Last week, we reported on the rumors of a PS4.5 coming in sometime in 2017. Sony still won't comment, but more rumors have come in saying that it will get an official release revealed before the...
What happened to you? Did you break?
No, there's like, it's a really long run-on sentence.
Well, you can make it your own.
Before the PSVR hits stores in October.
Don't Taco Bell this, man.
I know.
Too laid back for Taco Bell.
It is also rumored to now be called the PS4K.
Oh, 4K. Does that tie in?
Is it a trigger something?
Do you think that ties in?
This could be my solution. Could I have a Sony projector? So if I have a Sony box that I know it's got to work with their own fucking things, you'd hope anyway. That's my only thing at the moment. I've got an Onkyo receiver, Samsung Blu-ray player, and a Sony projector.
There's a lot of crossbreeding.
There's your fixer-upper.
I'm a world man rather than a one country man. But this could. Yeah, I'm very excited because I like any new console iteration. Oh, so nice. PS4K sounds great to me.
Sweet.
What's next?
Number Justin.
Four. Oh, I just wanted to say what the 4K was going to say. It just reminded me of like NBA 2K.
There you go.
Yeah,
NBA will have to be NBA 4K from there.
Number four.
Four.
Sometimes I just want to quit. I just want to walk out and just let you guys keep going.
The latest Xbox One update came out this week, and amongst many features, including letting you do party chat and Twitch broadcast, output party chat to both headset and speakers at the same time, and enable 16-person party chat, it also now allows you to purchase backwards compatible Xbox 360 games directly.
Now that's pretty cool.
That's cool. Really cool.
I'm stoked about that 16-person chat, man.
I'm scared of 16-person. Can you imagine what 16 people...
It would just be noise.
...would sound like playing a video game?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Just
crazy. Terrifying. Cluster. Absolutely terrifying.
If you're playing a spooky game, you'll be fine.
But yeah, but to be able to do... So, because we're always going on, it's so complicated. If you want to buy a 360 cross, you know, compatible... 360 compatible game on your Xbox One, you got to go on your... The easiest way is go on your desktop, log in for your account, go and find it, buy it, and then you can go and download on Xbox One. Because you can do it like this. Now you can do it on your dashboard. It's great. And there are some good new ones.
That's great.
So we did a list months ago. These are my now 10 favorite backwards compatible games available on Xbox One. It's not out yet.
Damn it.
Alan Wake, which just came out a week ago or so, which I just went back to, and it's really pretty. Really pretty. Most of these games you go back to.
No, actually, I swallowed my water wrong, but it was perfect timing, so I almost went with that.
She was just like...
Your reaction to Alan Wake is...
Yeah, I was like, bleh.
I really suggest going back to Alan Wake. I haven't got many like big games on here because we have new iterations of most of them. So I've gone with stuff you just can't get. Braid, 100%.
Yay.
Castlevania Symphony of the Night is now up on there. Fable 2, because...
Fable 2!
Fable's gone now. Lionhead is gone.
Yeah, so. They made a cool sim type of game. It's called Movies.
Yeah.
It's really fun.
Yeah, I remember that.
I still have it, but I lost my first disc, so I can never play it. Sad.
Mirror's Edge. This has been a page in Justin's diary. Mirror's Edge, one of my favorite games ever. We were just playing some Metal Slug X20.
Oh, Metal Slug.
Double XX.
You can get 3 or XX. Portal's still alive, because it's the only way to play Portal at the moment on your Xbox One.
Yeah.
South Park, The Stick of Truth, which is fantastic. It's like playing a whole season of the South Park show.
I've still never played South Park, Stick of Truth.
It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. It's like it's just a
JRPG. Yeah, how does it play?
It plays like a JRPG.
Is it?
Right, okay.
Yeah, it's an RPG, so.
Mm. How many people can play it?
Because it's by Obsidian, so.
Yeah, that's really good. Really beautiful. But there's a new one coming that will probably be better. Super Meat Boy and R-Type Dimensions, because it takes me back to when I was a kid.
Cool.
They're my top 10 recommended compatible games.
Thanks for the suggest.
Thanks for that.
I just passed that accidentally.
Yeah, I'm like, all right, well, if you want me to...
She's going
to
take out a red pen, correct?
I'm
like,
I'm like, I don't see Pac-Man Championship Edition.
No.
Which Pac-Man was it where you actually played as Pac-Man? It was a three-dimensional and you walked around and he had legs and all that?
That's terrifying.
I know what you're talking about and I'm blanking on the name of it.
Because my mom played it. I like came home from school one day and she was playing my play. I think it was like,
why has Pac-Man got legs?
What have you done,
like,
Mom?
Sorcery.
She's like, I bought a new game. And I was like, all right. It was weird. She's playing this weird Pac-Man game. And he was just...
I like him.
Does anyone remember the old 80s cartoon with Pac-Man?
Yes.
Where he did walk around and he had like a family or something? I can't even remember.
They turned him into like Mickey Mouse.
He had like a fedora hat or something.
Yeah.
He was a business guy.
He's a business guy, yeah.
Took care of business.
Creepy. That episode where he just does his taxes. Justin.
Number five.
According to the CV of a stunt actress, Warner Bros. May be about to announce a sequel to their sleeper hit, Middle-Earth, Shadow of Mordor. Her CV lists as doing motion capture work for the game at Blur, which, side note, is the same people that fucking made that Deadpool leaked trailer thing. They're the ones who made it, for everyone to know now.
Which one?
You remember how...
The leaked trailer.
Yeah, they're like, oh, it's a leaked trailer. That's the company that made it. Huh. Okay. Those of you who don't know.
All right.
Where'd you get your information from?
Oh, I know someone who worked on it, and I saw it before it came out.
Did you?
I did.
Did you leak it?
No, I didn't leak it. It was me.
At GDC the other week, I actually met a couple of the writers for Shadow of Mordor.
Oh, really?
They were really cool. But I thought that the ending, because I didn't quite make it to the ending, so I put it aside, and then I forgot about it, which I should go back and finish. But I thought the ending was a little open-ended, or they were hinting at a sequel or something for Shadow of Mordor.
Yeah, I'm sure it'll be a sequel to this game. It was a big sleeper hit. I don't think they were expecting it to do what it did.
Yeah, it was word of mouth because everyone's like, oh, it's a licensed property. It'd be terrible. And yeah. I was like, oh, it's Assassin's Creed, but it actually works.
Yeah. It was
the parkour in that game is good.
It was the Batman Asylum and the Nemesis system of that year.
A top tier CGI studio that made many video game trailers. Warner Bros. Has yet to comment.
What else you got, Justin?
Yeah.
Number six.
Six. Telltale's The Walking Dead Season 3 will indeed arrive sometime this year. It will take an unexpected approach to tie all of the series together. Currently, Telltale are releasing the... I can't even pronounce
it. Michonne.
Michonne miniseries spinoff.
Excellent.
Sweet.
That gets me very excited.
Oh, so you're a big Walking Dead Telltale fan, Alex. You haven't been playing Michonne, though, have you?
I haven't started playing Michonne, no. I am currently deciding, because I've played all this series on my laptop, and I am currently sort of like, do I just shift everything over onto the Xbox and play it on the Xbox?
Yes, because you get achievements.
Get achievements, but it would also mean I'd have to go back and play the early seasons.
It really doesn't matter. But I'm a big fan. Telltale games aren't as... The branch system doesn't work as much.
Are you delicately just cutting
the... I think it does. In the second season, it works better.
Yeah, okay. I just watched Katie play it. But the stuff I've read from people where they're really trying to fuck with it.
Yeah,
the end game ended up pretty much always coming around. It's like there's a lot of branching stories. You can see different stuff, but it'll come to the same thing at the end.
Yeah, that's a true point. Yeah, I mean, I love them. I just love how true they feel to the comic universe. I love how it tied into the comic universe. And, you know, I love the Telltale love affair, how they make me want it more and they make me wait.
Yes.
Every fucking time.
Yes, they do.
So.
Pepper in that?
So good. This is just a donut break to our viewers. Justin's still got news to go, but he's got chocolate sauce all over his hands.
It's about the pepper in The Walking Dead.
I like how two conversations broke out at the same time. What about donuts and what about Walking Dead? Because those are two things that go together well.
No, it's all confusing. Right,
you know,
you're
eating in The Walking Dead.
For me, okay, one reason why The Walking Dead appealed to me was as a kid growing up, I loved point-and-click games.
Yeah.
Absolutely obsessed with point-and-click games. So what this was for me was like the evolution of that, where then it became not just point-and-click, but with choices and consequences. Yeah. And it just was like, whoa, I was sucked in straight away.
Cool.
So is that your favorite Telltale series? Is The Walking Dead?
Yeah, I think so. Cool. Wolf Among Us is pretty close, but I've always felt more invested in The Walking Dead. Yeah.
Interesting.
What's your favorite, Megan?
Probably Borderlands, but I'm partial to that whole franchise. I am looking forward to the Batman.
Yeah.
Touch that one. That should be interesting.
They're doing the Batman one?
Yeah.
Woo! I have a hard time playing those like outcome decision-making games. Like, I'm still playing. It's been for a while now. The War one. This War of Mine. Yeah. Because you're out... Like, the things you do affect other people, and then when you're reading shit, I'm like, yeah, this is really messed up.
That's a heavy one, though.
Yeah.
Like, Telltale's really at least, like, I can't speak for The Walking Dead or Wolf Among Us, but, like, Borderlands is very humorous.
Okay. I could probably play that. Yeah.
I was going to say Game of Thrones, and I was like, wait, that's not humorous at all. That's probably the worst one in terms of how depressing it is.
It's not that great, the Game of Thrones one. Like, I didn't find it that great.
I didn't even know there was a Game of Thrones one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's
they push the only it, one, they push it out nice and quick, and so
that's the only
sucks.
One they stuck to their fucking schedule with when the episodes.
Yeah, it's literally
out.
The only one. They finally finished the first season of Borderlands, so that's good.
Justin, your last piece of news, please.
Yes.
Number seven.
Seven, seven, seven.
Yakuza Zero.
How is every news piece funny? How is that possible?
No, because I accidentally said Yakuzu because there was a zero.
That's just your brain. Now you're just laughing at your own brain.
Yeah, I'm kind of a funny guy. Yakuza 0 released in Japan in 2015, and we are now being told that it will definitely be released in the US and Europe in 2017. It is a prequel to the long-running Japanese series. Such exciting news, this.
Well, list Justin.
Of thank you, Justin.
Yeah.
Thanks. Oh, wait, I have one more news.
Oh, Jesus.
No, I don't.
All right, now we're going to move to some movie news. We're going to try and rattle through these because I want to get to the next parts.
The releases.
I want to get to other bits of the podcast. All right, we have eight things to chat about. Number one, Gambit. Originally slated for release on October the 7th this year, Fox removed Gambit from that slot a little while ago, but news now comes that the movie won't even shoot until the end of this year earliest. According to The Hollywood Reporter, this is a writer, Reed Carolyn, who wrote Magic Mike. Interesting choice for Gambit. Can rewrite the script. Director Doug Liman will be using his time to make The Wall, a film for Amazon Studios. Doug Liman,
wait, Channing Tatum's Gambit, right? That's
yeah.
The Magic Mike link.
So the film's seen a series of delays and problems. Channing Tatum had a very public salary dispute with Fox and then almost walked. And the original director, Rupert Wyatt, who did Rise of the Planet of the Apes, left production very early on. Doug Liman stepped in.
Wait,
but
did you say Channing Tatum?
Yeah, he's Gambit.
He's Gambit?
Yeah. Yeah. That's the correct face to pull.
Ooh.
Gambit is tall, thin,
like
lithe, and
yeah,
charming.
Yeah, like a filmmaker, I'm like, that's not my...
He'd be more like a young Wolverine. It doesn't make sense for Gambit.
Mm-mm. Have you guys seen A Guide to Recognizing Your Saints?
Yeah. It's a good film.
Yeah, that's the best Channing Tatum.
No, he's great, but he's not a Gambit.
I don't know, man.
Gambit's really skinny and tall and just agile.
Physically,
like,
but you know,
agile.
They could have done a different story. Maybe he like
I want a
had a hard
story.
Time and he just sat on the couch and he was like, I lost my cards. And
I'm beeping you out. I don't want to hear any more of this bullshit.
Channing, no!
So, I mean, this sounds pretty bad for the film, to be honest, because if Doug Liman's then going, well, I'm going to go make this film for Amazon Studios, by the time he comes back, people's intentions change and stuff shuffles. The film, though, is meant to be more of a heist. We'll fall into the smaller vein of superhero movies like Deadpool. I say smaller vein, but Deadpool's now the number one comic book movie.
Yeah, I was
going to
say, that's not
is
small.
Is this in the...
But in terms of scope.
In the Marvel Studios
No, this
universe?
Is Fox. This is Fox. This is in the X-Men, Deadpool, Fantastic Four universe. Separate from the MCU.
Yeah.
Because...
That beautiful MCU.
It was bought? Why is it separate again?
So, Deadpool?
You want me to do this right now?
No.
Yeah. Yeah, do it.
Okay. I mean, Justin says yes, I say no. Sharing a mic.
I'll just give half the story.
I cut myself with a butter knife. Who cuts themselves with a butter knife?
Just you. You're right, man. Yeah. Go wash your finger.
I just cut myself.
Go wash your finger.
Go wash your
it's good for your cuticles.
He's
you
not bleeding.
Back.
No, it's no I blood. I didn't break skin. I just like shredded.
Well, that's not cutting,
shut
is
up.
It?
Just,
you didn't break skin.
You basically
skin.
Rubbed a knife
I mean,
against your
bleeding,
finger.
But it's red. It looks like it's going to bleed. Too strong.
A long time ago, when Marvel weren't making movies, they sold off all of their rights to different companies. Fox owned them, other people owned them, Sony owned them. They all retained it, and Marvel decided they wanted to make their own movies and came up with the Avengers stuff. They still held rights to the characters basically no one gave a shit about, which were Iron Man and people like that. They started doing that, made them a ton of money. They decided they wanted to try and get back their other stuff, but as options go with movies, you have X amount of time to make another movie, otherwise it'll go back to the original owner. That's what happened with the Daredevil. Daredevil's meant to like turn into another film that Fox were trying to do, and then it returned back to Marvel because they didn't get it done quite in time, so then they did the TV show.
In your face.
Fantastic Four and X-Men still belong to Fox and do very well. Fantastic Four doesn't. Maybe that'll come back to them. X-Men does very well, so that's why you'll never get Wolverine turning up in Avengers. But Sony made the deal with Spidey because Spider-Man films they're making kept not making money, so they decided, well, we'll make a deal where we still own it, but Marvel basically gets to make creative decisions and play Spidey in the Marvel MCU.
Which is why he's in Civil War.
Yeah.
And okay, so is Marvel Studios having any involvement in the Spidey standalone?
Absolutely,
film?
Absolutely.
Okay, that's awesome.
It's a very that's weird relationship star. That's going on, but essentially it's Sony saying, look, we'll keep the money, but you get to do the things you want to with your baby. And Marvel making so much money, and they were just so happy to get Spidey back.
And I will just say, because of this split, as Justin has highlighted to me over the last few weeks, now you've got the Civil War... meeting a clash in the trailer where it looks like a schoolyard fight of five people because there's all the
mutants
are
scattered. You should have Wolverine and you should have Fantastic Four and you should have all that stuff.
But it's still exciting.
It's not really a civil war. There's just like eight people with a disagreement.
I gotta move on, guys. Number two, the Batman Lego movie trailers came out this week. Two of them, we just watched them before the podcast. Have you seen these, Megan?
Nope, I haven't seen them.
Do you like
yet.
The Lego movie?
I haven't seen it.
You haven't seen the Lego movie?
Yes, I know. I'm a terrible person.
Guess what? I've got a 4K version in the other room. We can't watch.
Everything is awesome.
It's the one reason you got your 4K and it can't
it really
even
is.
Watch
it's
it.
Fucking brilliant. Watch that movie. This looks great.
Yeah, great fun. Both of them.
Real palate cleanser. Very smart time for them, obviously, to release it.
Mm.
Yeah. I'm excited for this movie.
And, you know, not too many reveals or teasers or anything like that in them.
Not at all.
Just yeah, not like Batman vs. Superman where they showed you everything in the trailer.
Yeah. This seems to retain the humor from Lego Movie, which is great. Very irreverent, very self-poking, very acknowledgeable even for the studio's faults in previous films, which is cool. You got to see Batman. You got to see George Clooney's Batman nipples for a few seconds.
Yep.
Very cool. In more Batman news, Batman vs. Superman may have a 28% fresh rating on Rotten Tomatoes.
Tomatoes.
It's a special type of English tomato. You won't understand. But it has had the biggest opening ever for Warner Brothers, the largest March opening of all time, and also the biggest opening for a DC movie ever, with over $170 million.
Well,
now it's the fourth biggest movie of all time.
Made their money back.
Wait, the biggest movie of all time?
Internationally, through that, yeah. While it's done incredibly well, however, the film cost over $250 million, and Deadpool is actually the biggest success in terms of returns on investment, which really is all that matters, is your return on investment. In yet more Batman news, you can now search for Bruce Wayne's residence on Google Maps and explore the Batcave.
See, that's cool.
That is cool.
Where does he live? Like, in the United States? Where does he live?
Gotham.
Yeah, I know. But
someone look it up. Look it up on your Google thing.
If you're on Google
while I'm
Maps,
talking.
Okay, I'm going to just do it right now.
Number five, Lights Out was a YouTube short film, which had a cool little gimmick to it of a spooky lady whenever your lights were turned out, and this lady turned them back on and off to see the ghost. Well, the director of that came out a couple of years ago. It won a couple of some awards at festivals, and it got picked up by James Wan's production company, and he's produced it and turned it into a film that's coming out. And when did it say? I forgot now. June, I think it was.
Yeah, I forgot too.
This ball.
But it looks pretty cool, and I just want to highlight it because it's one of those nice little stories you hear of a little short film director who made a nice little film with an idea, and now he's directing this huge Hollywood movie. That
and it looked good. It had some, you know, suspenseful moments, maybe.
Yeah, it did.
Let's see how far the gimmick gets you.
I always find it interesting when you see people doing these short films and then again propelled to do a big film like that, and you see that trailer, and that trailer looks like a director who's been doing stuff for many, many years.
Yeah,
so it's interesting the hand of a
Did you
company.
Find the Batcave?
No, I found Bruce Wayne Co. And under reviews it said 5-star and he give great service.
I Google mapped
Bruce Wayne, and then it popped up in California and said, Bruce Wayne Co. And it's just 5-star, and he give great service. Exclamation mark.
That's what you'd expect from Bruce Wayne.
Yeah.
5-star service.
What do I type? Is Batman?
I don't know, man.
He's gotta you know, keep up that lifestyle, and sometimes he hits on hard times.
You just gotta make ends meet. Because let's be fair, the Batmobiles can't be cheap.
No.
Find his Batcave,
man. Number six. Use your internal voice. David Hasselhoff wants a Knight Rider movie. In an interview with Variety, he had this to say. I really enjoy this quote. And I'm not going to do it in a voice.
Okay.
I'm just going to read it as David Hasselhoff would. I see it as more of a continuation of the TV series, and they can add new characters or whatever, but they should basically keep the same feeling of the show. There are so many people out there that will absolutely freak out and love it. It would be Michael Knight kind of coming out of retirement.
Wrong password.
With his son and having adventures around the world and doing a Fast and Furious with the Knight Rider car. How cool does that sound? How cool could it be? End quote.
Wow.
That's exactly how David Hasselhoff.
It actually sounds pretty cool.
Yeah. I watched Knight Rider growing up.
Yeah,
me too.
TV series. Yeah,
there
you go.
Yeah.
Yep.
Am I screaming for
But
combat?
In a generation of GPS,
yeah.
Is that car that exciting?
Yeah, that's it.
Touché,
like,
good point.
Poor kid.
My iPhone's more powerful than your car. Yeah.
But there could be a great episode where Siri and him have a fight.
No, it should be Cortana. Number seven. An Indiegogo campaign just went up to create a project called Fast 9, The Fast and the Führer.
Oh my gosh.
This is real. The team has written a 70-page project and made a poster. The creator, Jordan Van Diener, says the film would include cameos from The Expendables, The Terminator, Doc Brown, Adolf Hitler's micropenis, and Donald Trump.
Jesus.
It also includes a scene where Vin Diesel and his crew travel back in time and stop 9/11. They've currently made $538 in donations of their $100 million goal. But with 2 months to go, anything could happen.
Anything
could happen. Final film news. Disney have gone crazy with sequels. So, upcoming sequels that we have are Alice Through the Looking Glass, Finding Dory, Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales, Cars 3, Toy Story 4, The Incredibles 2, what? Frozen 2, Mary Poppins 2.
That's ridiculous.
Wait a second, first of all.
Maleficent 2, Disenchanted, and Wreck-It Ralph 2.
Ooh, Wreck-It Ralph 2, yeah.
So not only are they remaking all their old cartoons into live-action stuff, but they're doing sequels to everything. First of all, is there anything on there that you guys are actually excited about?
Incredibles 2.
Yeah, Incredibles 2.
Incredibles
and
2. Toy Story's always been a solid one. I think 1, 2, and 3 have been pretty good.
Finding Dory, good, but I'm worried about that.
Ended on that note.
Well, true, but I mean, are they going to screw it up? Maybe? Are they going to screw it up?
Yeah,
that's true. I'd say Incredibles.
Incredibles?
Yeah. I know the kids are going to love Frozen 2. They're on a good thing
I'm
there.
I'm not asking the kids, I'm asking you.
Oh.
Well, he looks out for kids.
Disney's I think the Disney.
Are you
main...
the voice of the kids?
Well, you know, someone's got to represent the kids.
What is Disenchanted?
It's the sequel to Enchanted.
Ah, I see what they did
there.
It should be Dos Enchanted.
Dos Enchanted.
Oh, everyone's got Pirates of the Caribbean. Another one.
Five. Yeah.
Thank God.
Pick something. You picked Incredibles.
I picked Incredibles.
Justin?
Yeah, you picked that too.
Well, I picked that too, but I guess I'll go with Wreck-It
Ralph. Finding Dory. I'm going to go Finding Dory.
Either Finding Dory or Wreck-It Ralph 2.
Okay. So we're all gravitating. They're the same for me. So we're gravitating.
If the second half of Wreck-It Ralph wasn't so average, I would say Wreck-It Ralph 2.
Is there a Disney sequel that they're not making that you guys are interested in?
Yeah.
Is there a film or a franchise that you feel they've left in the dust and you would like to see them come back and pillage for extra cash? Because they're not making enough with Marvel or with Star Wars. They need...
Yeah, they need the cash,
they need
right?
to rape some of their old treasures.
Yeah.
Jeez, wow. I got dark.
Anybody, who wants to go first?
Not me, because I struggled with this one, so... You guys?
We'll go down this
way. Has anyone got a film?
Everyone's like tossing it my way. I'm like, I
very
just...
Megan's
well, they already pillaged Parent Trap a couple of times.
Ooh, interesting.
So they already did that. What about Herbie, the Love Bug? No, they redid that too.
They also redid that.
All right, I'm going... What's that one with that darn cat or whatever? Where the person scratches
Garfield?
Like help on the... back of the tag.
Yeah, that darn cat.
That darn cat.
I don't know that one.
I don't know. That dead cat. It's an old cat by now.
I don't know that one.
Johnny Tsunami Dobes.
I don't know this.
That darn cat. It's one of those really obscure old like 50s, 60s live action.
The trailer literally had everyone go, that darn cat!
Yeah.
I really don't know this.
Yeah, sounds like a great film.
That's all they did for 2 hours.
Adrian,
that
do you have
cat.
A Disney franchise you'd like to see a sequel to?
Well, no, not really. I mean, when I think about it, I love the first one so much that I probably actually wouldn't want them to do it.
Okay.
But maybe I'm just going to tell you one of my favorite Disney films randomly. Popeye.
Oh.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
love
a
that
creepy
film.
Movie.
It's a great film. Really
that's
good.
A creepy movie.
It's Robin Williams.
Robin Williams, yeah.
Yeah, if you've never seen it, go check it out. It's amazing.
You have nightmares.
Yeah. But I don't know if you could make... You couldn't really make
who
it.
Who would you cast
number
as
two
Popeye now?
Ooh.
Who could
Channing
you
Tatum.
Yes.
Channing
Tatum. Yeah.
Channing Tatum.
Oh, Jesse.
I'm pretty sure it's a Disney movie, but I could be wrong. Like a Cool Runnings 2? I mean, you had Hans Zimmerman in the first one. Yeah, I think it was.
I think that was Disney.
Yeah,
you know?
I haven't done Cool Runnings.
I wonder what happened to those guys. And also, like, maybe...
Do you want to see them back in Jamaica?
Just something, you know? Or, like, maybe they're training. I want to know.
Same guys?
It's based off a real story. So, like, what's the follow-up?
What happened next?
Yeah, like what they do. You know, they're like movie. Icons in Jamaica.
They went home.
Like, yeah, yeah, but I mean,
can we
like,
have the movie of them going to the premiere of Cool Runnings?
Yeah, that'd be cool. Literally cool. And then you could get Hans Zimmerman back and he'd do some cool sounds again.
Do some Batman v Superman.
No, sounds. he was the sound.
I know.
Yeah, yeah.
But so, now he's the Batman v Superman.
Yeah, but
dude.
That shit sucks compared to fucking Cool Runnings.
You know what I watched the other night? Dark Knight Rises.
Mm.
Hans Zimmer, awesome.
Yeah, right? Cool Runnings trilogy. Too. Yep. You just heard Cool Runnings the whole time you're listening to it.
That's very good film.
Alexander, did you come to any conclusions?
I'm going to take it all the way back to 1928. I'd like to see a live-action remake of Steamboat Willie.
Knew it.
Yeah.
Knew it.
Do you mean live-action with actual people and Muppets or like CGI?
I haven't gone that far yet.
Do you want to see a guy in a Mickey Mouse suit?
No, look, to be honest,
driving
I haven't...
driving his boat?
I struggled to sort of pick one that I'd want to see again.
There's
or,
just so many.
They've done
like,
most of them.
Yeah, or it's like looking... You know, going through my favorite Disney films and then seeing on the list that they've done four or five sequels to them, like The Lion King, for example.
Oh, yeah. There's a new one now this year.
I'm just glad they
called The Lion's Pride.
Yeah.
I'm glad they didn't do Beauty and the Beast, because that would be terrible.
They've done sequels to Beauty and the Beast.
They haven't done live action. They should never
they did
do
like,
that.
They did like
no,
specials
No, they are doing
live
action Beauty and the Beast.
Oh.
There's a great French one that just came out, I see, from the director of Brotherhood of the Wolf. With Vincent Cassell.
I do like wolves.
Oh, cool.
And there is a Disney TV show with all the princesses.
Yeah, I think that was a... Sorry.
No. Go.
Oh, no. I was just saying that there's the TV show on ABC, the Disney one. I can't think of it. It's all the princesses are on it.
Once Upon a Time?
Yes, Once Upon a Time.
I don't know.
Isn't that a kind of secret... Like a sequel of sorts?
Yeah.
Sort of.
Or like a crossover universe thing? I don't know. I don't watch it because I don't care.
You sound like you know a lot for someone who doesn't watch it.
I just wanted to be cool.
I'd like to see Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, Peter Dinklage, and Gary Oldman revisiting his role in what was that film that we saw the trailer of?
Draco?
Okay, basically, this is what I'm referencing here. There's a trailer for some film. Is it called 2 Feet?
This is a really great story so far. So
no, this is a true story. This is a real film. I can't remember the name, but it stars Gary Oldman.
Yeah.
Playing a I don't know
whatever
the PC term is a little person.
Yeah, little person.
Playing a little person, and it's essentially he's walking on his knees the whole film, and it's so obvious. And it has Peter Dinklage in it, and it's this sort of rom-com drama. Where, who's the lead actor?
Is there a trailer for this?
I can't remember, but look it up, and it just looks awful and embarrassing.
So you want that, but it's Snow White.
Yep.
All right.
Disney didn't do Willow, did they?
No.
That's...
I want to say that's a Lucas film.
I can't remember. I don't think that's Disney.
Yeah, Lucas
or
Jim
Henson.
The two would be cool with that, though, wouldn't it?
Yeah, Willow 2 would be cool. I would quite like... So my favorite Disney... film is actually Lilo and Stitch, but they've already bastardized that with horrible sequels. The one actually that I really loved as a kid, and then they actually, so I used to have one of these big books as a kid of all the Disney movies, like a huge hardback thing, and showed you just the animated ones, because you know they're numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, which one they are, and they struck one from which they still strike now. It's very hard to kind of find it, which is The Black Cauldron. I don't know if anyone remembers this. It's from the
80s. I just remember being really little and seeing it in the theater, and it was really scary and dark.
You remember it, though.
I vaguely remember it. It's just
terrifying
and dark.
It was. There were like skeletal armies. It was very much like a Lord of the Ringsy kind of thing.
Yeah,
I loved it. I was really into fantasy.
Blackwater?
No, it's called The Black Cauldron.
Yeah.
And they literally just struck it from the records. They pretend it never happened because it was too dark and scary for kids. I would like
yeah,
to
and
cool to
and
that.
Disney movies are dark and scary. I mean, Pinocchio, that is nightmare fuel.
Yeah.
Yep.
Dude, and the Beast was terrifying.
Dumbo when he gets drunk.
Dumbo is terrifying. The pink elephant scene.
Brilliant, but terrifying.
Yeah. Little
Fantasia.
Mermaid.
That's
terrifying. Everything's terrifying.
Okay, I found the film.
Mm-hmm.
The film is called Tiptoes, and it stars Gary Oldman, Peter Dinklage, Kate Beckinsale, Matthew McConaughey, and Patricia Arquette.
Wait, is there a picture?
What?
So look up the thing for that. And apparently director Matthew Bright was fired after he turned in his cut and the whole film was then re-edited. Peter Dinklage has said the original director's cut was gorgeous, but the people who fired Bright ruined the movie. So apparently it was meant to... I remember Taylor telling us about this. It was originally meant to be a very sort of earnest drama, but then it just was
with Gary Oldman on his knees.
With Gary Oldman still on his knees, but was just ripped apart and turned into this really.
Go watch the trailer. It's
bad taste.
Very funny.
Oh, no.
All right, tip-toes. That's all the news we have for this week.
Woo!
Yeah, we got through it.
Yeah.
Alex.
Oh God.
I need some money.
Do you?
Yes.
Because you've got a 4K projector out there.
Well, that's why I need some money. I just spent it all.
You spent all your money and it's not working. And you know what? I was thinking about that this morning when I was in the shower.
And always in the shower when you're thinking about my money problems.
Yeah, I see. Alex spent all this money on his 4K projector. What's he going to do? And you know what I shouted out?
Did you sing a song?
I sang a song.
What did you sing?
I sang... Chris Pratt, can you give me some money?
Give me some money.
Can you give me some money? So that means I'm about to talk to you about today's movie releases for
somehow
you guys don't get that little bit.
Somehow, the song Chris Pratt, can you give me some money, is our release section. It started, and I have no idea.
So the history. Should I even get into the history? I'll leave it a mystery.
Leave it. If you want to find out, go back and listen to our old
First few episodes.
I don't know.
So this is we've had Batman vs Superman last week, and this week is incredibly, incredibly slow on the movie releases. So I found three which might I don't know. Anyway.
Really?
Tickle your fancy.
Tickle your fancy. If
tickle
that.
Your imagination.
Float your
Look,
boat.
Have you guys often thought, I wonder what some of the Backstreet Boys have been up to?
Yeah.
No. I know what they're
I up wonder to. What Joey Fatone, not fat one as you could read it, but he was the fat one.
Oh, okay.
Nick Carter,
Are these their names?
Kevin. Mm. Yeah. Have you thought, what have they been doing since they were
never.
Smashing out hits in the 90s? Two of them have made a film.
Yes.
Nick Carter and Joey Fatone. Actually, Nick Carter wrote this film. It's called Dead Seven. And it's a post-apocalyptic western that follows a group of gunslingers as they look to rid a small town of a zombie plague.
Really?
Starring two former Backstreet Boys. You know about this, Justin?
Yeah. I've heard about it like... a long time ago. And also, I think there's NSYNC people in there as well.
It's a boy band bonanza!
Are you kidding? It's NSYNC and Backstreet Boys, yeah.
Actually, now that rings a boy.
In a zombie...
rings a boy.
We don't have enough boys. Someone...
Yeah.
How... Are you serious? This is a Western apocalyptic zombie film.
Yeah, there's pictures of it. You can Google it, and you'll see the pictures.
And this is something that was greenlit.
Awesome. Yeah.
I would kind of go see this movie, and I wasn't a fan of it.
I mean,
so
you can imagine
a big studio executive was in the office with NSYNC and Backstreet Boys, and was like, so do you guys want to make a new album?
Nope.
What projects have you got in mind? Zombie Gunslinger.
So it's called Dead Seven.
Dead Seven.
It's
a cool name.
I'm looking it up too.
It's legitimate.
It is absolutely legit. It's
Adrian confirmed.
Well, by legitimate, I don't mean it's legitimate. I mean it does exist.
Adrian thinks it looks fantastic.
So moving on. Dead Seven, check that out. Next, God's Not Dead 2.
There's a trailer. Sorry.
Well, what's it?
God's Not Dead 2. When a high school teacher is asked a question in class about Jesus, her reasoned response lands her in deep trouble and could expel God from the public square once and for all. This is directed by Harold Cronk. Stars Jesse Metcalf, David A.R. White. Any relation? And Ray Wise.
Is this another Jesus movie? We have three in the charts right now. Do we need another one?
Well, I think this sounds like God is going to
Easter.
Show his power.
Is this a genuine sequel? God's Not Dead 2?
I don't know.
Oh, wait, there's a comic book called God's Not Dead.
I don't think this is what that is.
Yeah. Wow. Okay, and finally, in this slow week, we have a film directed, written, and starring Don Cheadle.
Ooh.
Which is called Miles Ahead, which is an exploration of the life and music of Miles Davis.
Ooh.
He's War Machine.
So
not Miles Davis, but Don Cheadle.
Miles Davis is War Machine, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that also stars Ewan McGregor. And that, my friends, Dead 7, God's Not Dead 2, and Miles Ahead is this week's movie releases.
I'm going to say
movie
go see Dead
releases.
7.
Yeah, go see Dead 7.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's my pick.
Could be fun.
I really like Ewan McGregor.
there you go. Go see Miles Ahead.
Keep eating your donut.
Okay, and some game releases.
Game releases.
I know you've got some special ones you want to mention. All I've got to mention here is that episode 5 of the Minecraft Story Mode is out this week.
Telltale Games.
Telltale Game. As another Telltale Game, episode 2 of the Michonne Walking Dead Telltale Game. Episode 2 is out.
Telltale Game.
What else have we got? We have...
That Minecraft Telltale Game is actually really good.
Oh, really? I didn't even know that existed.
So it's funny. It's self-referential. It's cool.
We've also got Resident Evil 6.
Yes.
Yep.
So what about
so they're releasing Resident Evil 6, 5, and 4 backwards, weirdly. Bring them all to current gen.
There you
just
go.
Just sprucing them up a little bit.
I've also...
Because Capcom.
Ooh,
I've also got... StarCraft 2.
Yeah?
Yes.
Nova...
Trillion got as Vita.
No, give me some of these. I'll tell you if they're real.
Okay, Civilization Revolution 2 plus Force Showdown, Griffin Knight Epic.
That's not a real
Killer
game.
Instinct Season 3.
Yes, that's a real game.
The Last Door Season 2.
No.
MLB The Show 16. No. I think that's baseball.
Not a real game.
Knights of Azur.
Yes.
PS4. No Time to Explain.
Yes.
Organic Panic.
No.
RBI Baseball 16.
Yes.
Trillion, God of Destruction, and that's it. And you had some special mentions, which are way more exciting than any of those.
Adrift comes out this week, isn't it, Megan?
Yep.
Woo!
It does indeed.
Have you done some VR time in your time?
I have not, because I get motion sickness very easily. So I can't handle it. I can't do it. Which really sucks, because that's all there was on the GDC floor this year. And there were a couple of games that looked really cool, including one where you can become an anime girl. Like, it was a tech demo. And I wanted to wear they had a mocap suit and some sort of VR thing. I can't remember if it was Oculus Rift or what, but I ran to the booth when I heard that you could become an anime girl. And they're like, no, sorry, but the guy will do poses for you. And so the guy will do poses in mocap.
What?
And if you look at a screen, there's this adorable anime girl who will, like, you know, do all the cute little wee and yay and, you know, all that stuff.
Yeah.
And I was like, why is this not a game where you put on a virtual reality helmet and all of a sudden it's like one of those dating sims out of Japan where it's like, now the boys are, like, really there.
I was about to say, this is going to lead down a dark path
in the
future of VR.
If they're going to make porn for VR, this is just the animated version.
They're going to make, like, Cool World porn, where you're having sex with cartoon characters.
I was thinking about that movie the other day. Ooh, I was on a hike somewhere, and I don't know why I thought of that. But I kept thinking of Kim Basinger's line, when she's like, pencil dick.
Yes.
And I was like, why am I thinking of this movie? I don't know, but I haven't watched it in a really long... Oh, Brad Pitt is in that movie.
Oh, God. Yes,
that's
he is.
Right.
So you're thinking about Brad Pitt.
And probably. Yeah. I was trying to figure out how the hell I came up with the world. But...
Where a live-action person has sex with a cartoon?
Oh, this was on... I saw this on cable the other day.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it was on TV.
It's a very weird movie.
Yeah,
it's a weird movie. It came out after Who Framed Roger Rabbit. It's like the adult version.
Yeah. It was basically people want to have sex with Jessica Rabbit. So what do? We make a film where someone has sex with Jessica Rabbit.
It's got a super young Brad Pitt in it.
Is it super young?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like baby-faced.
Super clean and just like... Yeah,
well, I'm telling you, it's the future of VR. Cool World units.
No,
this is going to happen.
Cool World.
So, yeah, Adrift is on Oculus Rift. We played it last E3.
Yeah.
I had a bit of motion sickness also.
Yeah.
Because VR makes you feel a bit sick. Have you seen that roller coaster one with people in VR helmets on a roller coaster?
Yeah, that looks cool. Would you do that?
Fuck no.
No?
I won't go on a roller coaster. I'm not putting on something.
Putting this to and just eliminating
that. What are they going to do in there? It's like people feel sick in VR. People feel sick on roller coasters. Let's put them together. And people can't even see when people are vomiting. They won't even... All you'll know is the smell.
You would think it's an effect.
Wait a second. So people are... They're on an actual roller coaster.
Yeah.
And what
with VR helmets on.
And what is the VR helmet showing them?
It can be anything.
The demo that they showed was like... this battle through a city with like these crazy starfighters.
Oh, okay. As opposed
so they're like feeling
so
the motion.
You're getting the motion.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So
okay.
As they're going down.
I thought you were saying they're on a roller coaster being shown like...
Movies.
No. shown digital footage of being on a roller coaster. And
it's
like,
a new way to teach students. No, yeah. But you basically get the same footage but from backwards.
Yeah.
So the camera's on the back of the roller coaster. Anyway,
you could get like whiplash though, because when you're riding a normal roller coaster, you see one like that turns coming up, and once you go like, ah, yeah.
Plus, the benefit is if you die, you won't see it coming.
That's true. You'd see a pleasant movie.
Along with The Drift and some other games like that, but that's my personal favorite. Oculus Rift is out this week. So VR is here. How many people...
Is it here to stay?
It depends on what they do with it, though. So people are having a discussion about the potential for what it does. Instead of doing these weird little tech demos or mini games that are not even like real games, to have something like a 360 camera and then put your virtual reality helmet or whatever on and then be like, oh, hey, we have the, you know, Mars rover, or whatever it's called, Ranger rover.
Yeah.
Rover. I'm really tired, folks. But,
Jeep.
You know, if
the
you,
Mars
you know, or
Mars
you have some
car.
Mars car.
We'll just call it the Mars car. Save us some time. Mars car.
The Mars car. You know, or you have someone go back to the moon and it's like, see what the astronaut is seeing right now. And you put on your virtual reality helmet, you have a 360 camera. Mm-hmm. You're as close to space as you can get without being in space. I'm like, that's a potential I am hoping will come out of
VR.
Yeah,
awesome.
I think
amazing.
That's exactly where, because that's already, so it's not, it hasn't been out yet, but all of the, you know, up until now, and all of the kind of beta units and stuff, we're in stores like we talked about here. One was on Tom's on Abbot Kinney. So when you bought Tom's shoes, you could put the helmet on and be in Africa and see the good you were doing because the money from your shoes was going there. I don't mean that in a condescending way, but there's contrived stuff
what
with Tom's that
face.
Makes that not as genuine as a thing. But yeah, and then there's like real estate agents are doing it a lot. So you can go to the real estate place, put it on to see
around
places.
I went on a I went to some art gallery using an Oculus Rift.
Really?
From Melbourne University. Yeah.
Interesting.
That's cool.
And I like saw some famous paintings by like someone.
So this is the thing. These are the things they're already doing.
And I went on a tour of some architect's cool house that he built in the 1920s, which looks like it was
that
built
educational
now,
experience really stuck with you. Some guy.
But the some dude.
I learned a lot.
But it, you know, it was kind of.
But these are the things that we're like. Because, like, in the games industry, everyone likes to think, oh, it's VR, it's going to be for the games industry, it's going to be for movies, it's going to be for entertainment. It's like, no, it's already being used way more than for any of those things in these other places. Mm-hmm. And for, like, doctors want to use it for people when they can't walk anymore and they can get an experience of someone running on the beach and weird, you know, things like that, which are wonderful. Well, no, but it's just, like, things like options that people can have,
yeah,
you know?
Options are always
like,
good,
broadening the options of what people can do.
This sounds like what my dad thought when they brought out VHS. And there was, you know, the video shop. You know, you could go rent a video, and he thought it would be like, you know, a big library of videos on how to learn how to do things, and you know, you could get a video on how to make a table or something. You know what I mean?
But you could. You but know, those could. Used to exist.
Well, but you know, that's what he thought it was going to be. But then it was just, you know, full
films.
Of
films and porn,
movies and porn. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean,
but, so I feel like it could be the same sort of thing. You know what I mean? I think it'll go to entertainment because that's where the money is, right?
Yeah, but the thing is, for entertainment, you know, you're running into you know, you're running and splitting your audience, and you're running into for film in particular, which production costs, which is, you know, stupid. So absolutely, I think there'll be a small boom with it for a little while, and it'll die away, I think, very very quickly. Like, I'm sure you'll end up with a kind of vinyl, you know, group where it continues as a kind of cool thing to do. But I really think it's like this other stuff you guys are talking about. It's the implementation of far more practical, useful, interesting things, as far as I'm concerned.
I just hope there's no, like, on those, like, the space thing, there's no advertisement, because that's just blows, man. Like, this is Cabrinch. Buy your new underwear at whatever. Like,
Kmart.
At Moon Pants.
It's like, God, I was just in the middle of watching this solar flare, and you just fucked it up. I'm pissed now.
And now
a
I
game
need
like
a burger.
PT would be pretty amazing with a VR headset.
What there is that Paranormal Activity VR game.
Oh, I forgot you told me about that.
Yeah, we actually have a reaction video on IGN.com that you can watch about people playing that game and just... having it scare the hell out of people.
Which one?
Yeah.
Of the paranormal activity.
I just went, oh, that's PT, but way more terrifying. Yeah.
That looks...
It's on your face.
Couldn't do it.
Yeah.
Couldn't do it.
Yeah. Nope.
I want to try it.
DLC Fallout 4 Automatron finally came out, and so did Just Cause 3, what's it called? Island something. Jetpack.
Island Party.
Yeah, something
flying
like
people.
Jetpack
looks really cool,
Island
actually.
Party.
I'm not talking that down, because that looks like a much more fun way to play Just Cause 3.
Jetpacks?
We never talk about games with gold, but if you have an Xbox One, really use your games with gold this month, because from April the 1st to the 30th, The Wolf Among Us is available.
Ooh, sweet.
And more importantly, from April 16th to May the 15th, you can get Sunset Overdrive, which is one of the biggest Xbox One exclusives. Beautiful game. Sadly, not played enough.
I love it.
And you can get it for free.
I love that game. I think more people should play it. I feel like it was very underrated. Like people, it came out, I guess, towards the end of the year, so a lot of people didn't play it. It wasn't nominated for stuff because it was too late.
Yeah.
But it was very cool, very colorful, very vibrant.
Really gorgeous and original and fun.
Yeah.
It's a Jake Ryan Radio people, right? No? People who did that before? No? Did you ever play it? I'm asking you guys.
What?
Jet... Grind Radio?
No, it's not those dudes.
Jet Set Radio?
Jet Set Radio. No, no, no. It's kind of, it's got a similar feel.
It's got a similar feel, and it works, because as much as I love Jet Set Radio, that game was janky.
Yeah, Dreamcast. Dreamcast.
But it was so stylish, and the music was hot, and the whole concept
was so good, and you're just like, oh, I could create graffiti. I got into graffiti because of that, and then I realized, like, this is super messed up to do. Yeah, so I stopped graffiti.
Really nice influence.
I have really strong morals.
Yeah, bro. All right, that's it for releases. Box office. Here are the top four films that came out last week. You, Justin, it was you, me, and Nicola last week. You two got it right in the top three. I got it wrong because I went back and listened to it. I actually said what you said, but you guys are already gone. I didn't want to be boring, so I switched it up, and I shouldn't have. Number 12 is Eye in the Sky. That's a movie. Number 11 is Kung Fu Panda 3. Number 10, still clinging in there, is Star Wars The Force Awakens. Number 9 is Hello, My Name is Doris.
Oh, that's very quirky.
Number 8, do you know what that's about?
It's actually Sally... I almost said Sally Jesse Raphael. I am Sally really tired. Fields. Sally Fields actually plays a 60-something-year-old office worker who falls in love with a much, much younger man.
Huh.
And her, I guess, awkwardly trying to date him. It's supposed to be pretty good.
I saw Sally Fields, and it was awkward. Because I saw her, and I was like, oh, fuck, she's awesome. What did I say? We're literally standing like this. And I turned to her and went, you're awesome! And she turned to me, she was like, thanks, and walked away really weirdly. I was like, you... blew it, man. just gonna sit it quieter.
Yeah. Number 8, London Has Fallen. Number 7, Deadpool. Number 6, 10 Cloverfield Lane. Number 5, Allegiant, the Divergent series. Number 4, Miracles from Heaven. Number 3, My Big Fat Greek Wedding 2. Number 2, Zootopia, still reaping in tons of money. And number 1, Batman v Soup.
Soup Dude.
Did
Dawn,
it.
Of Dawn of Justin.
Super Bat.
Super Bat Dude.
Super Bat Dude.
What do we think is going to be next week's box office?
What comes out?
Well, you just had Dead Sevens coming out. Was that good?
There you go. There's your answer.
I think it's safe to say nothing on that list is going to move.
I'm going to say the top three is going to stay exactly the same.
Exactly the same.
I'm going to say number 4 is going to be that Daz 7 Zombie NSYNC Backstreet
Dead album.
I wonder if they do the soundtrack for that, you know? That'd be interesting.
That would be a good selling point, especially for nostalgic 90s girls who would... go see the movie and go buy the track.
Yep. Something for everybody.
Little song of some.
So we're getting near the end of the podcast. Everyone will be relieved tonight. Before we do, a little game.
Uh-oh.
So while we're in Palm Springs, Katie bought me this little present called Geek Gamer Trivia Questions.
Oh, man.
So we do different quizzes on here, Megan.
Okay.
Sometimes we just do really simple things. Sometimes we steal them from IGN.
And you borrow them.
No,
borrow.
I flat out go in there and I just roll.
No, you borrow them.
You borrow them. You borrow otherwise, them. I'm going to have you pay me, I mean us, a substantial fee.
Sometimes we go crazy and we do like a game show and we have boxes you'd have to reach in and you do like
eat horrible things.
Eat horrible things. Yeah. Horrible. We're not doing that today, so don't
worry.
Okay,
good.
Today's nice and simple.
No,
because
that's like a crazy one. You don't want to
I was given all these cards with questions.
Okay.
So we're going to do 10 of these. Does anyone have a coin on them?
Yeah. Which one?
Just whatever's big. We want to flip it. Quarter. Basically, there's two questions in each one. I'm going to go by card, just random.
This one's from 1970. This quarter.
All right. So everyone's going to have to... we need a piece of paper, don't we?
Is this like multiple choice?
Yeah. Well, most of them are multiple choice. Can you rip those in half?
What if you just shouted all at the same time?
Because I don't think these ones are... I'll be honest, I haven't thought this one through. Normally we think this stuff through and I practice it. Okay. But today it was a last minute thing. All right. So the coin will go around the table. You'll flip it for which one we do on each card. Everyone will write down their answer.
You don't have enough pens.
Now, we accrue points throughout the year. So you're playing, Megan, for the guests.
Oh, okay.
So you have a responsibility.
All right.
Because whoever's our last guest of the year gets the prize. And last year, Justin won, which I haven't validated yet.
I want to...
Dude,
Do you tell him or I
want
tell
him? She.
I'm a she.
It already expired.
He won a Disneyland VIP passport for the year.
Wow.
So he can go whenever he wants.
You gave him an expired passport.
No, he actually gave me a piece of paper. And I'm like, this is the best
paper.
It's
already blacklisted, so if you show your face at Disneyland, they will take you away.
So what am I doing? Writing down...
You're going to write down the answers that you think to this. If I think one's okay for you guys to shout out, we'll deal with that when we come to that bridge. But right now, you're going to write down the answer.
Write it down, don't show you.
Yeah, don't show it till I say. Alex, you start with the flip of the coin for if we're doing the first question or the second question. So basically, on each of these, one is multiple and one isn't.
Is there a timer?
Yeah, yeah. We're gonna do. Let's do like a 60-second timer, Rachel.
Okay. Heads is one.
Yeah.
There's stopwatch.
What we got?
Tails.
Okay. Multiple choice. You ready?
Yep.
I'll just flip it.
There's a timer. There.
The phrases "he's on fire" and "boom shakalaka" were made popular by which famous sports game? Was it NBA Street, Madden NFL, NBA Jam, or Ultimate Table Tennis?
Everyone knows it was Mario Kart.
Stupid.
It's a freaking stupid.
What were the last two?
Is it NBA Street, Madden NFL, NBA Jam, Ultimate Table Tennis? He's on fire and boom shakalaka.
Do you want me to do a recap of how they sound?
Yeah, yeah.
Please.
He's on fire!
Boom shakalaka!
From downtown!
Sounds like Ultimate Table Tennis to me. All right, everybody. Everyone got an answer?
Yeah.
Okay, what do you get?
No, I'm going to answer at the end.
Huh? No, you want to do all of them first?
Yeah.
All right, we'll do all of them. Then reveal at the end. Fine.
Oh, no, do you want to
fine.
Do?
No, no, we'll do it that way.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to flick.
I'm in the zone. I'm thinking. Yeah.
You just want to think. Okay, I see what you're doing. It's like an end of year quiz. In order to perform Chun-Li's spinning bird kick attack in Street Fighter 2,
Nash,
what controller and button combination must be used? Is it forward, down, down, forward, kick? Press kick repeatedly, button mash and hope it happens, or charge down, up, and kick to do her spinning bird kick attack.
Say the first one again.
Forward, down, down, forward, kick. Press kick repeatedly, button mash and hope it happens, or charge down, up, and kick. Some of these may be too easy. I haven't looked for any of these, so... Okay.
Just quietly feeling confident over here.
Oh, good. Thanks for sharing. And number three.
I'm just winging it. Kind of like that Taco Bell. Oh, shit.
So this one, we're going to go to the closest 10 because there's no multiple choice. How many dots are there on a Pac-Man board? How many dots are there on a Pac-Man board? The person who gets, let's just say the person who gets closest.
10? Okay.
Depends how many you've eaten.
Wait, dots? Are you talking about like the big ones or the all the dots?
All the dots.
The dots.
Okay. Ooh, and are you including Pac-Man? Oh.
No.
Are you counting the eyes sort of the ghost? Sure. Are you counting the cherry spots that are taking up a dot?
Sure.
Okay.
All right, spinning the coin. Question four.
Stop looking at me. Ooh, maybe Gregory ready.
Daxter from the popular platformer franchise Jak and Daxter is what kind of animal? A weasel. B, an otter. C, a squirrel. Or D, an otzel. A weasel, an otter, a squirrel, or an otzel. Daxter. From the game Jak and Daxter.
What was the game?
I thought there was a rabbit.
Yeah.
Rabbit is not on my board, I'm afraid. But if you want to write rabbit, feel free to take that.
God damn
it,
what are the choices again?
Weasel, otter, squirrel, otzel. Pay attention, Justin.
Is it okay if you spell...
You can spell whatever you want, however you want, as long as you say it right.
Sweet. I can't remember because I'm getting confused with another game.
I am too.
Yeah, me too.
If initially I was like, Sly Coop? Yeah, dude. I was like, that's not the same.
No, I was thinking Crash Bandicoot for a second. Ooh. I was like, I know what that is.
Those
Crash
drops.
Bandicoot.
The Ooga Booga Mask.
That's an Australian reference, everybody.
All right. Question five. In Super Mario Bros. 2, the first boss you encounter was defeated by... A, jumping on it. B, shooting fireballs at it. C, throwing darts. Or D, egg it. Jumping on it, shoot fireballs, throw darts, or egg it.
I don't
This one I do remember. This is the first answer I feel confident about.
Ooh.
Yeah, 10 Cloverfield Lane is the answer.
10 Cloverfield?
Batman is the answer.
The answer is Batman. Yeah.
Batman.
Question 6. Everyone ready?
Yeah.
Created in 1980, Missile Command was popular and successful at arcades until the mid-90s. Ports of the game, and remakes have sold millions of units worldwide. But what is the object of the game? Is it A, to shoot down incoming aircraft, B, to destroy the enemy's cities, C, to save the princess, or D, to defend the cities? Shooting down the incoming aircraft, destroy the enemy's cities, save the princess, defend the cities. Tails.
Oh, it's Deadpool.
Okay, no multiple choice here.
Shit.
In the arcade-style puzzle game, or Mario, Dr. Mario. The font is really weird.
Or Mario. Mario. That's not a puzzle, man.
The font is really weird. Look at this.
Nah, dude.
Dr. Mario. Players match corresponding colored capsules with viruses to destroy them, much like real doctors do. Two music selections were available for the game. Fever and...
Fuck. That was the actual name.
Fever and Fuck. That's just a Friday night. Two music selections were available for the game. Fever and what? Dr. Mario.
Dude.
Dr. Mario.
London Has Fallen.
Do you know the answer to that one?
Yeah.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Into the last three questions.
There's only two songs.
Everything to play for. I don't know what we're playing for. Dignity?
Expired Disneyland passport.
Another one with no multiple answers. In Diablo 3, there are five playable classes. Barbarian, Witch Doctor, Demon Hunter, Wizard, and... Barbarian, Witch Doctor, Demon Hunter, Wizard, and something.
I don't know.
I'm just going to guess.
Yeah, some of these you just can't
Diablo 3, right?
Diablo 3.
Okay, cool.
Well, Justin's going to win.
I was playing it
like you mean it.
Months ago.
Last two questions.
Oh, last two? I don't even have space.
These could be the... Adrian, well, buddy. Hmm. These could be the ones.
Great.
They could be.
I'm feeling confident.
Okay, good.
Still, I'm still feeling confident.
In a little game called Final Fantasy VII.
Oh! Let's see how much you like the game now.
Players are able to customize...
It was a long time ago.
...to customize their character's access to spells and abilities by using something called... Was it A? Materia. B? Gaia. C? Cosmic Essence. Or D? Vespers.
Star Wars Force Awakens. The Force.
Materia, Gaia, Cosmic Essence, Vespers, or Midichlorians.
Two of those.
Two of those things were in it. Two of those words are in that game. Anyway, keep going.
I am.
Final
question.
Oh, final. Yeah.
Everyone ready?
Yeah.
I tell you what, I'm going to give you the choice. There's one with no multiple, and there's one with multiple. What do people want? It's democracy.
I don't care.
I don't give a sh.
Megan, you're the guest.
Let's go with multiple choice.
Multiple question.
Why'd you have to choose that one?
Because there's a chance I might guess one right.
Fair enough. What are you doing now?
I don't understand this question.
Just read it.
If I read this question out, let me know if it makes sense to people. What does MAME mean to you? Does that make sense if I give multiple for that?
Yep.
Okay. Is it A, arcade? B, a gaming convention? C, a text-based game variant, or D, tearing opponent's limb from limb to limb?
Tearing opponent's limb from limb.
Now, the problem I have with this question is I feel it's very subjective, since it says, what does it mean to me?
Yeah. New question?
How about a different question?
I'm going to do a different question. I don't like that as the last question. No. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's very subjective.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Last question. Multiple choice again. Despite the concerns of Nintendo management, The Legend of Zelda met with success when it was released in the USA in 1987. In order to defeat the final boss Ganon, Link had to strike him with a silver arrow, his magic sword, his ocarina, or a magic spell. A silver arrow, his magic sword, his ocarina, or a magic spell.
It's an ocarina.
It's like a flute.
It's like it's kind of
like a tropical flute.
Can yeah, you, it's like a little round thing.
And it goes boop.
What? I think that was the Wind Waker. Bring your sails.
I was terrible.
I was gonna do.
Here we go.
No, that's not it. All right, let's do this.
Are you ready?
Yes. Right.
Let's see who won.
All right, everyone, put your pens down so you're not cheating.
You're gonna get the card if you win it. Whoever has the most cards at the end.
Okay.
Oh, hang on. If people have more than one, no, that doesn't work because people might have the same answer.
We'll just tear them into however many parts.
Exactly.
That's what I'm saying.
The first question was, the phrase is,
boom shakalaka,
and
he's on fire.
Yeah, were made popular by which famous sports game? NBA Street, Madden NFL, NBA Jam, Ultimate Table Tennis. Everyone, please tell me your answers, starting with Megan.
NBA Jam?
I said Street, but I immediately regret that.
Justin.
NBA Jam.
NBA Jam.
The correct answer was NBA Jam. 3 points.
I knew it was one of those games.
Adrian loses out because of his...
Feeling less confident now.
Two Street.
Yeah, got one.
3 points.
What?
What?
Only one.
No. 1 point each, but three. Like, three points.
Oh,
okay. Three points to the people.
One.
Question two. In order to perform Chun Li's spinning bird kick, which sounds like spinning bird kick. In Street Fighter 2, what controller and button combination must be used? Is it forward, down, forward, kick, press kick repeatedly, button mash, or charge down, up, and kick? Let's start with Alex.
Charge down, up, and kick.
Same thing.
Charge down, up, kick.
I said Vince would know from IGN, but I guessed A.
Megan is correct. It is forward, down, down, forward. No, I'm lying. Sorry. It was charged down, up, and kick.
Yeah.
I was like, what? That's impossible.
I actually thought it was forward, down, down, forward, forward, and kick.
Maybe I think it was Konami code, like up, up, down, down.
Where are we doing? What are we doing? Batman. How many dots are there on the Pac-Man
just
board?
A bunch of
I like this one.
Yeah.
Do you know what? I'm going to leave the Pac-Man one till last. I think that's a good closer.
Okay.
All right.
Daxter from the popular platform franchise Jack and Daxter is what kind of animal? Is he a weasel, otter, squirrel, or otzel? Justin.
Oh, shit. Squirrel? That's horribly wrong.
Adrian.
Rabbit or squirrel?
Megan.
Weasel?
And?
Otzel.
He is, in fact,
I didn't know what that is.
An otzel.
Yeah, I don't know what the...
I don't know what that is.
I think it might be
it's
made
like a,
up.
Type
Jack
of
and
cat
Daxter.
Thing.
Is it?
Yeah, sure. You saw the answer. I'm
that's a trick
question. I did like your shrug, though, Megan.
You're an otzel.
You take that back.
In Super Mario Bros. 2, the first boss you encounter was defeated by jumping on it, shoot fireballs at it, throw darts, or egg it. Megan seemed pretty confident with this one.
So you, Birdo shoots eggs, you jump on the egg, you pick the egg up, and you throw it back at Birdo.
You're going to say egg it.
I'd say egg it.
Adrian. Seems pretty confident. Are you as confident?
Yeah, very confident.
Jumping?
Justin.
Jump on it, bitch.
You gotta jump on it.
You egg it. Megan was, of course, correct.
Yeah, I didn't play the second one.
I also gave away the answer. I just realized as I was talking, he's like, shut up, Megan. Shut up, Megan. You just told them exactly how you defeat Birdo.
They already had it. Wrong. Next question. Created in 1980, Missile Command was popular and successful and blah, blah, blah. What is the object of that game? Is it shoot down incoming aircraft, destroy the enemy cities, save the princess, or defend the cities? Alex.
You defend the cities.
Justin.
Defend the cities.
Adrian.
Defend the cities.
And Megan.
Batman.
Yes.
I'm afraid the correct answer was Superman. Defend the cities.
Yeah.
So kind of Superman.
Dun, 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 dun.
In the arcade-style puzzle game, or Mario, players match corresponding colored capsules with viruses to destroy them. Two music selections were available for the game, Fever and Adrian.
I didn't answer this one. Yeah.
You're opting out. Just give a word. Just give us any word.
1812 Overture.
That's a good word. Megan.
Fever and Batman.
Fever and Batman.
Batman.
I think you might have a one-track mind, Megan. That's what I'm learning
here. I told
here.
You the answer to everything. The correct answer is Batman.
That is true. Alex?
Fever and Sweat.
Ooh. I thought you said sex.
Like sweatpants?
They're like sweating. He's got the
sweats. Oh, okay. So still fever and sex.
That's kind of like sexy.
Justin.
I actually didn't know it, but I said cold.
So close. It's chill.
Yeah.
Fever and chill.
Can I get like a half point? You know,
really? No, really not. No. Really not. Okay. In Diablo 3, there are 5 playable classes. Barbarian, Witch, Doctor, Demon Hunter, Wizard, and Justin.
Monk.
Alex.
Elf.
Well, I thought there needed to be a ranged option there, so I was thinking like a ranger or a rogue type.
Rogue Ooh, type.
I like that.
Megan, is your answer going to be Batman by any chance?
No, it's not going to be, but I think you would have said wizard, because I put sorcerer. I was trying to remember what my character was, and she was like an elven sorcerer or something. She wielded magic, and that's all I remember.
It's monk, isn't it?
It is monk. Yeah. It's monk.
Because I created a monk, and I punched everything.
Nice.
That's what monks do.
It has a good sound effect. It's like, whoosh,
whoosh, whoosh. Last three. Where are our points at right now? Who's got how many points?
I've got 1, 2, 3, 4.
I've got 4.
2.
I've got 2.
All right, a confident 2 down there.
Take him down.
This is it.
Yeah, it is.
Last three questions. You could both still win.
Unless we really get this up.
In Final Fantasy VII, players are able to customize the characters' access to spells and abilities by using...
Damn.
It's
Materia or Vespers.
It's Materia.
Materia, Gaia, Cosmic Essence, or Vespers. Adrian, what did you get?
First thought was Materia. And then I was like, oh, but Vespers is familiar as well. Because I think they do have Vespers or something or other in that
in
game.
In Italy, you drive them.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Unless you think of Espers, and then that's actually a different game.
Did you both go with Vespers?
I went Vespa.
Nope. I went Materia.
Materia.
It's Materia.
Gaia.
It's Materia.
It is indeed Materia.
Yeah.
Points for Megan, points for Justin.
Justin, you're going to win this now.
Final two questions. Despite the concerns of blah, 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 in order to defeat the final boss Ganon in Legend of Zelda, Link had to strike him with a silver arrow, his magic sword, his ocarina, or a magic spell.
A magic spell that fired the ocarina with a silver arrow. No, a magic spell.
Magic spell. Adrian.
Ocarina?
Megan.
I said master sword.
Silver arrow.
Silver arrow.
I almost went with silver arrow.
The only reason why I know this, because I was watching this show called The Gobergs, and he got to the last level with Zelda, and he paused it. His brother came and beat it, and I was like, oh, it's an arrow.
So you didn't really know. You've never played the game. That doesn't count. Take a point
away. No, I never
away.
Beat it. My grandmother beat it, though.
So here's what's going to happen
that
right now.
That makes me
your
feel
mom
old.
And your grandma playing games.
I know. Tell me about
my
it.
My grandmother played Toad.
We got one more. Grandma.
Last question, which was how many dots are there on a Pac-Man board? Now, here's the deal. Justin, how many points do you have right now?
1, 2. No, you can't do this. I only have 3 points.
No, how many points do you have?
I have 3.
How many points does
4.
He have?
He's
like,
got 1,
he's got
2,
six.
3, 4.
No, that's not fair. He's got 6. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay. Alex?
I've got 4.
Adrian?
8.
Adrian?
2.
Megan?
How many dots?
Can we combine?
How many points? No, how many points do you have so
far?
Oh,
I just have 3 so far.
So you have 3. So what's going to happen here?
I hope I win.
It's whoever's closest gets the point. Which means basically Justin's going to win. But if someone gets it on the nose, they get 5 points.
That's or what about if you get it on the nose, you win the whole thing?
Well, basically you will.
What? You will.
Yeah.
I still.
All this hard work.
Because this is incredibly tough and none of you are going to get on the nose. But if one of you does, you deserve to win the whole game.
Okay. I hope I win.
How many dots are there on a Pac-Man board, Alexander Chard?
I've got a photographic memory, so...
Pretty, it's an easy one for you then, really.
Yeah, it's easy. 75.
75. Justin.
You didn't have to ask the others.
111.
Oh, I thought you wrote 3. That's why I was like pointing at it going like, what? He didn't write 3 in Roman numerals. He wrote 111.
So smart.
Adrian.
Old school.
113.
113. Yeah. Really? Banking. Is that what you wrote down? Is that just what, no, you, what did you write down? You wrote 100? We have to go with what you wrote down.
Oh, 100.
100.
I put 90.
90 for Megan. The correct number of dots on a Pac-Man board is 240.
Yes!
Justin
you
is
suck!
Well done, Justin. You win 1 point towards... Yet another Disney pass at the end of the year.
200 and what?
40.
Oh. Wow.
It's a lot
Scoop
of points.
Back in there, buddy.
Wow.
I mean, that's what it says.
Tried to cheat me of the points.
Could
I'm
lie.
A champ. This one goes out to my homie, Batman.
Batman is
I
always
will,
the correct answer.
I will still debate that he wrote 3 in Roman numerals.
That's about all we have time for, and undoubtedly it's all that you have time for. Thank you very much for sticking with
Thank
us.
Thank you.
Where can people find people, Megan?
You can find me at Megan underscore IGN, M-E-G-H-A-N underscore IGN. Tweet at me with all the anime and video games and wrestling stuff.
Wrestling.
I'm a big wrestling fan. And WrestleMania is this weekend, so I'm curious to know what you guys think is going to happen.
Who's your wrestler?
Who's my choice? Well, there's multiple matches as it stands, but the one I'm looking forward to the most is Shane McMahon versus The Undertaker, now that I know that Shane McMahon can still do all the crazy shit that he used to do, even though he's like 10 years older now.
Undertaker was my favorite wrestler growing up.
Is he still going? Yeah. Is he still going?
And he's still going.
Remember on that first game they brought out?
WWF Royal Rumble?
Yeah, that was awesome. Undertaker was great on that.
I've been an Undertaker fan since 1991.
Holy
shit. There's Undertaker and Kane, and they had that crazy backstory.
Can you tell me then, who was the guy? No, I just remembered it. The two times we talked about wrestling on this show, and I couldn't remember. I like wrestling for only about a month. Well, it's really just not for me. But there was one guy that I liked, and he had this weird face paint. And I could never remember his name. I just remember it was the Ultimate Warrior. Anyone remember him?
No. Was he had the blue pants?
Yeah, that's WCW, man.
Well, what? No. But so Sting was WCW, and then Warrior was WWF.
I thought he was talking about Sting.
He was in the World Wildlife.
It could be Sting as well, like WCW, Crow, Sting.
Yeah.
You know what I mean with the colorful paint?
The colorful paint is Ultimate Warrior with the long hair and he shoots the ropes. That's Ultimate Warrior.
Yeah, when people say paint, I just think like WCW Sting. I'm like, no.
No, don't trample on my dreams. My memories of being a child.
Well, you said only for a month, man.
That month meant a lot to me.
I don't know. You didn't sound committed.
With all those wrestle buddies.
Yeah, speaking of wrestlers, Hulk Hogan just won $100 million lawsuit for some sex tape.
Yeah, he did. Gawker's going to have to fork some money over.
Yeah. Yep.
Wait, he had a sex tape?
He got the Hogan out.
He got his hoagie.
Did he go, oh, brother? Yeah.
You'll have to watch the tape to find out.
Let me just pull it up real quick.
So that was Megan underscore IGN. Yeah?
Yeah. Cool. That's my Twitter handle.
Okay. Is there anywhere else people like? Do you like people to go anywhere else? Or is Twitter your home?
Twitter. I don't have an Instagram or anything, but you can find all my articles and videos on IGN.com. So, yep.
Awesome.
There it is.
Adrian, where can people hassle you sexually but with words?
I don't know. I don't
you flustered him.
I think I've got an Instagram.
Do you?
Yeah.
I'll be honest, only you would know, Adrian.
Yeah.
Chances are no one else listening will have any clue.
Let me just look it up.
Excellent. Justin, where can people hassle you?
Yeah, it's Radley. That's ITSRADLEY. Just find me on whatever.
Are you on Twitter? Instas?
No, not on Twitter. I think I made one. No, I didn't.
You're fucking useless. Seriously.
No, I just use Instagram. That's like, picture me, man. Send me a picture.
Well, how about now when the people won't get their updates because of the stupid new thing that started?
What? I don't know. What are you talking about?
Have you seen that?
You have to turn on notifications.
Basically, there's a new algorithm. Yeah, but you turn on notification, that just gets sent to your fucking phone every time someone posts.
Yeah, which is really annoying, right?
Yeah, I don't even have that. I just have
for
it.
What? No, but Justin, so do you know what's happening now? So a new algorithm which will only poll the best things and only show you the best pictures that the people you're following are doing, which means a small amount get to see it and then the algorithm decides what's cool and will only show you that. They won't show you people's feeds and they won't show you things in order anymore.
Okay, I'm seeing the feeds right now.
No, it hasn't happened yet. It will be the downfall. This is the end.
Wait, so when's that changing?
It's happening soon. Okay. So people are doing this whole thing of like, press this thing for instant notifications. Like, you're great. Then your phone buzzes every fucking time anyone posts
anything.
It's
really annoying.
That sounds terrible. I won't annoy you because I don't post that crazily, but you can check out my pictures. I have like cool dogs. And
he does have cool dog pictures.
I have really good photos.
You've never posted a photo of you and me together.
That's true.
Al's got a beautiful one on your motorbike.
I do.
Anyway.
Yeah, that picture so I can post it.
My Instagram, Adrian. Well, sorry.
What's your Instagram?
It's just my name, Adrian Auld.
Oh, it's like a puzzle.
Yeah, yeah. Adrian Auld, one word. Surprisingly, one word altogether, Adrian Auld. And
how do you spell Auld, though? Because that's
a A-U-L-D.
A-U-L-D.
Yeah, it takes a long time to say for four letters. So think about that.
Australia. Do you know a Cody Fern?
Yeah. That's
Cody Fern.
Went to school,
oh, yeah. There's only six people in Australia. So we all know each other.
He was in the the pictures of that Australians in film night.
Yeah. We were there.
Yeah, Codes, we call him.
Yeah, the Codester.
Actually, people do call him Codes.
Fern the Code Master.
Yeah. Cody, this guy in the middle here.
This is my life.
No. Fern Gully.
This is actually
they,
my life.
They call him Fern Gully.
No, okay. I don't know.
Oh, do you remember that Robin Williams Bat song in Fern Gully?
No.
It's great. Alex.
You can find me on Twitter at Alexander Chard. Same goes for Instagram. And on the PSN and Xbox thingos, I'm Rainbow Chard.
Like
I probably
fish.
Won't play any multiplayer games with you, but you can send me a message.
I would.
I can send you voice messages on
Send me
on
voice
Connect.
Messages. Yep.
I'm Mr. Al White on everything on all the social medias and my website, but please go to wearetessellate.com. Over there, you can link through straight to our podcast, and please subscribe. Please leave us a review. Please leave us ratings. Tell us you hate us. We don't care. and yeah, we're on all the social medias. We are Tessellate as well. That's with two S's, two L's. Because words, tough. Thank you very much. We'll be back next Tuesday with Nate. Well, hopefully. Oh, I forgot to say, actually. Nate. We were going to hold a little eulogy because Nate, I'm afraid, died last week.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, he was in Texas.
And he got chainsawed.
Where people go to die.
And it went south very quickly. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah. There was a rattlesnake under a bridge.
Yep.
Yeah, it all happened pretty quick from what we hear.
What we hear. But he was, you know, he had my camera with him, at least to nurture those final
Nightcrawler.
Yeah, so, I mean, and that in turn is going to lead to an amazing found footage film.
It will. We'll bury his body first.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll take that footage and siphon through and see if we can make something profitable.
Yeah, make ourselves a bit of cash.
Yeah. So one moment of silence, please, for Nate.
Geeks!
Geeks!
Geeks! Geeks!